BGMC. The biblical truth lives here.
The ancient Hebrew scriptures foretold of the Anointed One, Yeshua HaMashiach. The Messiah Yeshua came to call the people back to the truth of His word and to follow that righteous path. Yeshua then called Jewish men to be His disciples, and after His death and resurrection, those Jewish men told the world about the Jewish Messiah. Now, after 2,000 years, Beth Goyim Messianic Congregation has that same calling of those Jewish men, telling all people, both Jew and Gentile, about the proper ancient path, teaching the Route 66 King's Highway from Genesis through to Revelation, and how you need and can get back to the proper roots of the faith and a closer walk with God. Now, let's hear the message.
Let's go get a blessing. Turn to the book of Leviticus, chapter 23.
Vamos al libro de Levíticos, capítulo 23.
Leviticus, chapter 23.
Leviticus, capítulo 23.
This is message HB005.
Este es el mensaje HB005.
Yom Teruah.
Yom Teruah.
Remember his word Teruah and its meaning.
Recordando su nombre Teruah y su significado.
Everything you hear during this message,
todo lo que vas a escuchar en este mensaje,
will be in English and in Spanish.
Va a ser en inglés y en español.
When I go to the readings in Scripture,
cuando vayamos a la lectura,
if you're reading in Spanish, please just read ahead.
Si estás leyendo en español, por favor, lee con nosotros.
Everything I say tonight will be translated into Spanish.
Todo lo que se va a decir hoy día va a ser traducido al español.
Let me give you a little synopsis of the message.
Déjame te doy una sinopsis del mensaje.
There's a great difference in spirit and in truth.
Hay una gran diferencia entre espíritu y verdad.
Between Rosh Hashanah and Yom Teruah.
Entre Rosh Hashanah y Yom Teruah.
In this holy day message,
en este día santo,
we're going to take a deep look at into this statement.
Vamos a mirar bien profundamente en este mensaje.
We're going to look at the diamond of the word Teruah.
Vamos a mirar el diamante de la palabra Teruah.
We're going to look and see the reason.
Vamos a ver la razón.
Yehovah brought all those leaders to Israel.
Por lo que Yehovah trajo todos los líderes a Israel.
Right before this day.
Justo antes de este día.
To offer one last opportunity.
Para ofrecerles la última oportunidad.
To do things right.
Para hacer las cosas bien.
All right, let's get to the message.
Vamos al mensaje.
Leviticus 23, verse 23 through 25.
Levíticos 23, versículo 23 al 25.
Vayikra 23, verse 23 to 25.
Levíticos 23, versículo 23 al 25.
Yehovah said to Moshe, tell the people of Israel, in the seventh month, the first of the month, is to be for you a day of complete rest, for remembering, a holy convocation announced with the blast on the shofar. Do not do any kind of ordinary work, and bring an offering made by fire to Yehovah. Amen?
Amen.
When you hear the name Yehovah,
cuando escuchas el nombre de Yehovah,
for those that are new to the congregation tonight,
aquellos que son nuevos en la congregación hoy día,
that is the name of the Father, Yehovah.
Ese es el nombre del Padre, Yehovah.
Yod Hey Vav Hey spells out the name Yehovah.
Yod Hey Vav Hey se habla el nombre de Yehovah.
Look at verse 24 again, please.
Versículo 24 otra vez.
Tell the people of Israel in the seventh month, on the first of the month, is to be for you a day of complete rest for remembering, a holy convocation announced with the blast on the shofar. Amen?
Amen.
Today is that day.
Hoy día es ese día.
As we looked around the globe today and even found pictures.
Como miramos alrededor del mundo e incluso vimos fotografías.
It was the first day of the biblical month.
Como fue el primer día de un día de bíblico del mes.
God does not follow the pagan calendar.
Dios no sigue el calendario pagano.
Well, how do you tell the beginning of the month?
¿Cómo tú sabes del principio del mes?
The moon goes from little on the right.
La luna se va desde pequeña en la derecha.
Then gets in the middle of the month, it gets to be full.
En la mitad del mes se hace luna llena.
Then it gets little towards the left.
Y se empieza a opacar a la izquierda.
And then at the very last part of the month,
y la última parte del mes,
it looks like a little banana.
Se parece a una pequeña banana.
Or many of you might like plantains.
O quizás alguno de ustedes les gusta.
Bananas or plantains, whichever you want.
Banana es banana.
Okay, then it goes to black.
Y después se hace negra.
Then you have to wait a day.
Después tienes que esperar un día.
And you gotta look.
Tienes que mirar.
And when you see the first sign of the moon again,
cuando observes la primera luz de la luna otra vez,
that is the new month.
Ese es el nuevo mes.
So today we're And tonight, as the moon came out,
hoy día, como la luna salió,
we're here on the exact day that God said to be here.
Estamos en el día correcto que el Señor dice que estemos presentes.
You're doing something that is 3,000 years old.
Estás haciendo ahorita algo que es de 3,000 años de antigüedad.
You're following a commandment of the God who created all things.
Estás siguiendo un mandamiento de un Dios que creó todos los mandamientos.
Make it 74 up front. Okay, the key here is the word remember.
La palabra clave aquí es recordar.
The Hebrew word for remember,
la palabra hebrea para recordar,
is the word zikron.
Es la palabra
or zikron.
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 It means memorial.
Significa recordar.
Reminder.
Recordar.
Remembrance.
Y recordar.
I didn't give you.
Recordatorio.
Okay. It means those things.
Significa esto. Significa today, memorial, recordatorio y recuerdo.
Oh, you got it. Okay.
Yeah, from yesterday.
One word. It was one word. Okay. 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 So here, why are we here to remember?
¿Por qué estás aquí para recordar?
Why, you're going to see through the message.
Vas a ver por el medio de este mensaje.
In this teaching tonight.
Y en esta enseñanza,
that God wants you to remember the past,
que el Señor quiere que recuerdes el pasado,
so you don't make the same mistakes.
Así no cometerás el mismo error.
Some people keep making the same mistakes.
Mucha gente sigue cometiendo el mismo error cada vez.
So the Lord is saying, I want you to remember.
El Señor está diciendo que yo quiero que recuerdes.
Because people like to make the same mistakes, right?
Que la gente le gusta cometer los mismos errores, ¿verdad?
So the Lord set apart a day.
El Señor apartó un día.
Before his holiest day of the year, Yom Kippur.
Antes de el día más santo del año.
He said, sound the shofar when you see the moon.
Él dice, suena el shofar cuando mires la luna.
And then I want you to have a holy convocation.
Y quiero que tengas una convocación santa.
A holy convocation is a day that it's set aside.
La convocación santa es un día que tú lo separas.
That you don't do any work.
Que no haces ningún tipo de trabajo.
So starting at sundown tonight.
Empezando hoy día a la caída del sol.
Till sundown tomorrow.
A la caída del sol del día de mañana.
God said to stop everything.
El Señor dice que pares todo.
This is my day.
Este es mi día.
And you should have gotten here early.
Y deberías haber estado aquí presente temprano.
Because it should be a very special day for you.
Debería ser un día muy especial para ti.
Not just showing up when service starts.
No aparecerte cuando el servicio empieza.
Do you ever remember when you were a child?
¿Te recuerdas cuando eras un niño pequeño?
And maybe your family celebrated birthdays.
Y quizás tu familia celebraba cumpleaños.
And your birthday was getting closer.
Y tu cumpleaños se estaba acercando.
And you would hint to your parents.
Y tú estabas
Say it loud.
Le daba pista a los padres.
Okay. You would say to your parents, hey, my birthday's coming up.
Le decía a tus padres, mira, mi cumpleaños se está acercando.
My birthday's coming up.
Mi cumpleaños se está acercando.
You can get me that new toy I've been really wanting.
Puedes darme ese nuevo juguete que en verdad yo quiero.
And you would say this all the time.
Y tú lo dices esto todo el tiempo.
And as that day got closer, you couldn't wait for that day to happen.
Mientras el día se acercaba, no podías esperar a que ese día llegue.
The same should be for us, for God's holy days.
Para nosotros, para los días santos del Señor.
You should anticipate his days.
Deberías anticiparte sus días.
Because it's a day of remembering.
Porque es el día de recuerdo.
Okay, and then we sighted the moon.
Vimos la luna.
And We stop everything we do.
Y paramos todo lo que estamos
haciendo. Now look at verse 24 again.
Miremos el versículo 24 otra vez.
Tell the people of Israel, in the seventh month, the first of the month, is to be for you a day of complete rest for remembering, a holy convocation announced with the blast on the shofar. Amen?
Amen.
So there's a couple of things we need to look at in this sentence.
Aquí hay un par de cosas que necesitamos mirar en este verso.
The first part.
La primera parte.
The people of Israel.
La gente de Israel.
Or the sons of Israel.
O los hijos de Israel.
Okay, that encompasses everybody.
Eso significa todos.
The second part of this sentence.
La segunda parte de del verso.
That is important to understand for this day.
Es muy importante entender para este día.
Is complete rest.
Dice un descanso completo.
Complete rest.
Completo descanso.
Number three.
Número tres.
The word remembering.
La palabra memorial.
The word remembering.
La palabra memorial.
Fourth thing.
La cuarta parte.
A holy convocation.
Una convocación santa.
A holy convocation.
Una convocación santa.
And finally, the fifth thing that we're to do.
Y la quinta parte que vamos a hacer.
Is the blast on the shofar.
El sonar el shofar.
Blast on the shofar.
Soplar el shofar.
So let me tell this again because we're an education ministry.
Déjame te repito porque somos un ministerio de educación.
Because remember, this is the day.
Recuerda que este es el día.
That Messiah comes back. I'm not going to say what year.
Que el Mesías va a regresar. No voy a decir en qué
año. Nobody knows the day or the hour. Remember,
people. No, nadie sabe el día ni la hora.
Because all the Christians are saying you don't know the day or the hour.
Porque todos los cristianos van a decir tú no sabes ni el día ni la hora.
You're absolutely right.
Estás en lo correcto.
Because you know why?
Porque sabes.
Because I gotta look for the moon.
Porque tengo que mirar la luna.
I gotta look for the moon.
Tengo que mirar la luna.
Okay, but you'll see when we get to the book of Revelation, you're going to see some things.
Vas a mirar cuando lleguemos al libro de Apocalipsis.
And then when we get to the book of Matthew, you're going to hear it out of Messiah's own mouth.
Y cuando vayamos por el libro de Mateo, vas a escuchar de la propia boca del Mesías.
So, number one.
Número uno.
People of Israel.
La gente de Israel.
That encompasses everybody who wants to follow God.
Eso significa todo aquel que quiera seguir a Dios.
Complete rest.
Reposo completo.
Remembering.
Recordando.
Holy convocation.
Convocación santa.
And the shofar, the blast on the shofar.
Y el soplar del sonido del shofar.
We're going to go through those things tonight.
Vamos a ir por cada uno de esos puntos hoy día.
Now, we start off with the people of Israel.
Empezamos con la gente de Israel.
Who are the people of Israel?
¿Quién es la gente de Israel?
See, when it says house of Israel,
cuando dice casa de Israel,
that means the children of Abraham, Yitzhak and Yaakov.
Eso significa Abraham, Yitzhak y Jacob.
When it says people of Israel,
cuando dice la gente de Israel,
that means the Jews and the Gentiles that are living among them.
Eso significa judío y gentil que están viviendo juntos, junto a él.
So that means everybody, Jew and Gentile.
Eso significa judío y gentil.
Because God wants everybody to worship him.
Porque el Señor quiere todos que lo adoren.
Okay, amen. Do I have an amen for that?
Amen.
All right, you can say amen. This is in the Catholic Church. You can say, when I say something that you like, you say, what?
Amen.
It means you agree.
Estás de acuerdo. Eso significa que estás de acuerdo.
The word amen means I agree.
La palabra amen significa estoy de acuerdo.
Okay, the second part we're looking at.
La segunda parte que vamos a mirar.
Is complete rest.
Es un completo descanso.
This is a day given over to Jehovah the Father.
Este fue un día que fue dado por Yehovah el Padre.
So once that sun went down,
una vez que el sol se ocultó,
until the sun goes down again tomorrow,
hasta que el sol se oculte otra vez el día de mañana,
this day is for him and him alone.
Este día es para él y solo para él.
So people ask me, can I go shopping?
La gente me pregunta, ¿puedo ir a
comprar? Because I forgot to get something.
Porque me olvidé de comprar algo.
The answer is no, because then you're making the pagans work.
La respuesta es no, porque estás haciendo trabajar a los paganos.
See, if nobody was going to the store, they wouldn't be open.
Si nadie fuese a las tiendas, no estuvieran abiertas.
Now the key now here is remembering.
La palabra clave aquí es recordando.
As we go through the message, you're going to see what He wants you to remember.
Durante este mensaje vas a ver el por qué Él quiere que recuerdes.
Now the next part is we're going to skip remembering.
Vamos a pasar recordando.
We're going to go to Holy Convocation.
Vamos a ir a la Convocación Santa.
What does a Holy Convocation mean?
¿Qué es una Convocación Santa? ¿Qué significa?
That means you got to leave your home.
Eso significa que tienes que dejar tu casa.
And come into a gathering with all the believers.
Y tienes que reunirte con todos los creyentes.
So you say, well, I don't want to go.
Si estás diciendo, yo no quiero ir.
Well, then you've now broken the commandment.
Entonces está rompiendo un mandamiento.
And God keeps records.
Y el Señor mantiene archivos de.
Did anybody ever go to a Jewish accountant?
¿Alguien se ha ido a un abogado judío?
Aren't Jewish accountants like the best accountants ever?
A un contador judío.
Because they know the rules.
Porque ellos saben las reglas.
And God is a Jewish accountant.
Y el Señor es un contador judío.
So he's going to say, when you miss his holy days,
él va a decir, cuando pierdas uno de los días santos,
that's going to be a debit.
Eso va a ser una deuda para
and ti. When you get up to heaven, you're going to have to pay that all back.
Y cuando tú vayas al cielo, vas a tener que devolver y pagar
todo.
The
problem is you've left your clothes and your wallet behind because you're dead.
Pero el problema va a ser que todo dejaste atrás porque estás muerto.
So a credit to your account is
el crédito a tu cuenta es
that you have made it to God's holy day.
Que tú llegaste a los días santos de Dios.
So a holy convocation is meaning separation.
Una convocación santa es una separación.
A gathering with the believers, the followers of the Torah and Yeshua.
El reunirse todos los creyentes que siguen a Yeshua.
And then
y después
there's this.
Viene esto.
Called the shofar.
Que se llama el shofar.
It's a tool. It's an ancient Hebrew tool.
Es una herramienta antigua, hebrea.
It's a weapon of mass destruction.
Eso es un arma de destrucción masiva.
It is worse than a nuclear bomb to the devil.
Es más peligrosa que una bomba nuclear para.
And
para
I'm sure you heard it a lot during the worship.
Estoy seguro que escuchaste.
I couldn't even hear Rabbi. I'm like, goodness gracious, it's loud. All right. So, but it sounds something like this.
Suena así.
Amen.
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 This is the only holy day.
Este es el único día santo.
Where you're commanded.
Cuando estás comandado.
To sound the shofar.
De sonar el shofar.
Okay, so it's something that we're going to remember. We're going to look at today.
Es algo que vas a recordar y vamos a mirar hoy día.
Now something that might be confusing a lot of people.
Quizás algo confunda a muchas personas.
It was confusing you for many years.
Estaba confundiéndote a ti por muchos
because
años.
Because you were, you know, all messianic congregations aren't the same.
Todas las congregaciones mesiánicas no son lo iguales.
And even as I was walking across the parking lot earlier before the sun went down.
Incluso cuando estaba cruzando el parqueadero.
I had my hat on.
Tenía mi
and I look Italian.
Y me miraba italiano.
Don't I look Italian?
Italiano?
Forget about it. So this lady goes, oh, Happy New Year.
Y esta muchacha dice, Feliz Año.
See, many Jews are saying, Happy Rosh Hashanah.
Muchos judíos dicen, Happy Rosh Hashanah.
But it's not the New Year.
Pero no es el nuevo año.
Hold your place there in Leviticus and turn to Exodus chapter 12.
Vamos a Exodus capítulo 12.
Exodus chapter 12. Shemot 12.
Capítulo 12.
Verse 2.
Versículo 2.
Exodus chapter 12, verse 2.
Exodus 12, versículo 2.
Exodus chapter 12, verse 2.
Exodus 12, versículo 2.
When you got it, say amen. Okay? It's in the beginning, right after Genesis.
I know. Come on, Robert.
Well, you're still turning and everybody else is there. I just wanted to help you there, son. Genesis, Exodus 12, versículo 12. Todo bien. Okay, now what does it say in verse 2?
¿Qué dice en el versículo 2?
You are to begin your calendar with this month. It will be the first month of the year for you. Amen?
Amen.
Now as you go further in your reading, it talks about Passover.
Mientras sigues leyendo, vas a llegar a, va a hablar de la Pascua.
So why are the Jewish people celebrating New Year's tonight?
¿Por qué la gente judía está celebrando Año Nuevo hoy
see,
día?
This is what happens when you don't read your Bible.
Esto es lo que pasa cuando no lees tu Biblia.
And when you follow tradition.
Y cuando sigues las tradiciones.
See, here at Beth Goyim, we don't teach any tradition.
Aquí en Beth Goyim no enseñamos ninguna tipos de tradición.
Everything you're going to hear tonight, I'm going to show you right there in the Word of God.
Todo lo que vas a escuchar hoy noche va a estar todo en la palabra de Dios.
So the beginning of the calendar year is during what we would know as the springtime.
El principio del calendario es lo que nosotros conocemos como la primavera.
Now, I'm going to read you a little something because maybe you didn't hear this.
Te voy a leer algo, quizás no escuchaste.
And we're going to do it little by little.
Vamos a hacer poco.
Because
poco.
I never got this to Rabbit. Okay? I'm going to read you what the Jewish people are doing tonight, what they think they're doing.
Voy a leerte lo que la gente judía está haciendo hoy.
Rosh Hashanah is the anniversary of the creation of Adam and Eve.
Rosh Hashanah es el aniversario de la creación de Adam y Eva.
A day of judgment and coronation.
El día del juicio y de la coronación.
A sounding of the shofar.
El sonar del shofar.
Now for those that are taking notes,
aquellos quienes están tomando notas,
this next part's going to come from Mishnah.
En la próxima parte va a venir del Mishnah.
Sanhedrin 38b.
38b.
Mishnah Sanhedrin 38b.
Mishnah Sanhedrin 38b.
Jewish tradition believes that Adam was created on this day.
La tradición judía piensa que Adán fue creado en este día.
See, this is what happens when you smoke pot.
Esto es lo que pasa cuando fumas marihuana.
Wasn't Adam created on the sixth day?
¿No fue acaso Adán creado en el día sexto?
Pass along. I mean, what are you talking about?
¿De qué están hablando aquí?
Anybody with any logic would go.
Cualquiera puede con.
He was created on the sixth day.
En el sexto día.
But this is the first of the month.
Este es el primer día del mes.
Did God say we should have two Rosh Hashanah? This is what happens when you smoke marijuana.
Es lo que pasa cuando se fuma marihuana.
Your mind turns to mush. Okay, maybe some mushrooms are doing it. I don't know. Opiums or things like that. But here, when you get away from God's word,
aquí cuando te alejas de la palabra de Dios,
you know, saying that Adam was created on this day,
cuando se dice que Adán fue creado en este día,
but very specifically in the book of Genesis, it says the sixth day.
Pero muy específicamente en el libro de Génesis dice el día sexto.
Well, what happened on the first day?
¿Qué pasa en el día primero?
God said, "Let there be light."
El Señor dice que sea la luz.
And there was light.
Y fue la luz. Se hizo
but the
luz.
Earth wasn't here yet.
Pero la tierra no estaba aquí todavía.
So here, they're saying Adam was here on the first day.
Aquí dice que Adán estaba en el primer día.
Okay? Therefore, Yom Teruah is known as the birthday of Adam.
También dice que Yom Teruah fue, es el cumpleaños de Adán.
And some other traditions that happen, just so you can get a little background here.
Lo que pasa es solo para que tengas en cuenta esto.
Okay, here's a tradition that goes on.
Aquí hay una tradición que está sucediendo.
There's what a lot of Jewish people are doing tonight.
Lo que mucha gente hoy día está haciendo hoy día.
Are eating apples.
Están comiendo manzanas.
Dipped in honey.
Sumergidas en miel.
Because they say this will be a good year for you to come.
Porque dicen que este va que sea un buen año para ti el año que viene.
Didn't Eve bite an apple?
¿Acaso
they say?
No mordió la manzana.
So you want to bite an apple to have a good year?
So necesitas morder esta manzana para tener un buen año.
That's not what God wants you doing on this day.
Eso no es lo que el Señor quiere que hagas en este
a
año.
A lot of things you'll hear.
Muchas cosas que escuches.
You'll hear people say blessings to you.
Vas a escuchar que la gente te diga bendiciones a ti.
They'll say Lashana Tova.
Te va a decir Lashana Tova.
Tikvatev.
Tikvatev.
Vayetachatiem.
Vayetachatiem.
May your name be inscribed in the book of life.
Que tu nombre sea inscrito en el libro de la vida.
But we haven't gotten to Yom Kippur.
Pero aún no hemos llegado a Yom Kippur.
So your name's going to be inscribed in the book, and you got all this sin that hasn't been forgiven.
O sea, así que tu nombre va a estar inscrito en ese libro y va a tener todo ese pecado antes de llegar al final que no ha sido perdonado.
So we start there. Why do I start there?
¿Por qué empezamos aquí?
Because I want to see what it's really about.
Porque quiero que mires lo que en verdad es.
Go back to Leviticus 23, please.
Regresemos a Levíticos 23, por favor.
Leviticus 23.
Levíticos 23.
Leviticus 23.
Levíticos 23.
Verse 23 to 25 again.
Versículo 23 al 25 otra vez.
Yehovah said to Moshe, tell the people of Israel in the seventh month, the first of the month, it's to be a d- to be for you a day of complete rest for remembering. A holy convocation announced with blasts on the shofar. Do not do any kind of ordinary work and bring an offering made by fire to Yehovah. Amen?
Amen.
Here's another key that we miss in verse 24.
Aquí tenemos otra clave que estamos dejando pasar por alto.
It says it is to be a day for you.
Dice que debe ser un día para ti.
Meaning that it's personal.
Significa que es personal.
Let me say that again.
Déjame repito otra vez.
When you see God say a day for you,
cuando mires que el Señor está diciendo un día para ti,
that means it's personal.
Eso significa que es personal.
Because you don't have to be here.
Porque no tienes que estar aquí.
In Deuteronomy, it talks about the three times a year that you have to be in Jerusalem when the temple's there.
Se habla que en Deuteronomio que tienes que estar tres veces en Jerusalén.
Okay, that you have to be there.
Cuando estés al templo, tienes que estar
this
ahí.
Is not one of them.
Este no es uno de esos.
But he wants those people who really love him
pero quiere que, a su gente, que en verdad le ame,
to be here on his day.
Que estés aquí en su día.
Yom Teruah is about remembering to come to God's house.
El Yom Teruah es acerca de recordar que debes venir a la casa de Dios.
It's not about remembering a new year, for it is not the new year.
No se trata de recordar el nuevo año porque no es un año para ti.
It's not about eating apples and honey.
No se trata de comer manzanas y miel.
It's remembering what God did for us.
Es recordar lo que el Señor hizo por nosotros.
Look at verse 24, please.
Versículo 24.
Tell the people of Israel, in the seventh month, the first of the month, is to be for you a day of complete rest for remembering. A holy convocation announced with the blast on the shofar. Amen.
Amen.
Zikron. A day to remember that is set aside.
Un día de recordar para apartarlo.
A holy convocation where you're going to leave your homes.
Una convocación santa donde vas a dejar tu casa.
And come to the congregation.
Y venir a la congregación.
And you have to plan for this too.
Debes planear para esto también.
Like our friend Dave in the back there.
Como nuestro hermano David.
He's calling me. When's the day going to be?
Está diciendo, ¿cuándo va a
ser? I'm new to all this.
Yo soy nuevo en todo esto.
So, I mean, but I like that you did that, Dave.
Pero me gusta que hayas hecho eso.
Because it showed a heart that wants to please God.
Porque enseña un corazón que quiere complacer a Dios.
It shows a heart that's trying to please God.
Enseña un corazón que está tratando de complacer a Dios.
Because it's a day for you to remember.
Es un día para ti que recuerdes.
Because if you remember God's things,
porque si tú recuerdas las cosas de Dios,
He's going to forget your sins.
Él va a perdonar tus pecados.
Let me say that again, everybody. Maybe you didn't get it.
Déjame repito otra vez.
If you remember God's things,
si recuerdas las cosas de Dios,
and do His commandments,
y hace sus mandamientos,
then He's going to forget all your sins.
Así él va a perdonar todos tus pecados.
Because when you get up to heaven,
porque cuando llegues al cielo,
God is going to weigh out your life.
El Señor va a pesar tu vida.
Did anybody ever steal anything?
¿Alguien ha robado algo?
Like a pencil off of somebody's desk.
Como un lápiz del escritorio de alguien.
A piece of bubble gum when you were a child.
Un pedazo de chicle.
Okay, lots of chicle, right? We got lots of chicle stealers. Okay? Now, did anybody ever have a bad word fly out of their mouth?
¿Alguien ha tenido palabras malas que salen de la boca?
French fries.
French fries.
Or shalom.
Shalom.
You know, somebody cuts you off and you go and you say something bad.
Y cuando alguien te corta y tú dices algo malo.
Did you ever, did you ever look at a lady?
Hombres, han mirado alguna muchacha.
And go, oh my goodness.
Y dicen, oh,
boy, she goes to the gym a lot.
Ella va bastante al gimnasio.
Ladies, did you ever say, oh, he looks so handsome?
Mujeres, algún día han dicho,
oh, I just love the cologne he's wearing.
Solo me gusta la colonia que
so if you've stolen something,
si tú te has robado algo,
you're a thief.
Tú eres un ladrón.
If you've said a bad word, you're a profaner.
Si dices una mala palabra, tú estás profanando.
If you've looked at somebody in lust,
si estás mirando a alguien en codicia,
you're somebody who covets.
Alguien que está codiciando.
And when you get up to heaven,
y cuando llegues al cielo,
God's going to say to you,
el Señor te va a decir,
I remember the time that you were in that candy store.
Cuando estabas en la tienda.
I remember that time that the person cut you off.
Yo me recuerdo esa vez que la persona te cortó, te cruzó en el
camino. I remember that time you were looking at that woman.
Yo recuerdo esa vez que estabas mirando a esa mujer.
And she was nice. I made her nice.
Y ella era bonita. Yo lo hice bonita.
And she was dressed not too many, many clothing.
Ella no estaba vistiendo mucha ropa.
How are you going to pay God back?
¿Cómo tú vas a devolverle a Dios?
Well, you start by doing His holy days.
Al hacer sus días santos.
By remembering to come to His holy days.
Recordando y hacer sus días santos.
To start doing what He wants you doing.
Cuando empiezas a hacer lo que Él quiere que hagas.
Look at verse 24 again.
Mira el versículo 24 otra
vez. Tell the people of Israel, in the seventh month, you're the seventh month, the first in the month, is to be for you a day of complete rest for remembering. A holy convocation announced with the blast on the shofar. Amen?
Amen.
Okay? The blast on the shofar.
El sonar de los shofares.
Is sounding, this blast.
Es sonar, es un son de shofares.
Is the word in Hebrew, teruah.
Es la palabra en hebreo, teruah.
This teruah.
Este teruah.
It's not it's not Rosh Hashanah.
No es Rosh Hashanah.
It's an alarm. It's teruah.
Es una alarma, es teruah.
So God wants you sounding this alarm.
El Señor quiere que suenes esta alarma.
To call for a holy convocation.
Para que llames a una convocación santa.
To remember the feast that is part with the shofar.
Para que recuerdes esta fiesta que es parte del shofar.
See,
Rosh Hashanah
has a different feeling.
Tiene un sentido diferente.
Hi, it's the New Year. Happy New Year.
Hola, feliz año.
Lashana Tova.
Lashana Tova.
But when you're sounding the shofar,
pero cuando suenas el shofar,
when you're saying Yom Teruah, this alarm,
cuando dices Yom Teruah, es una alarma,
it is completely different,
es completamente diferente,
than the New Year.
Que el año nuevo.
And the devil has lied so greatly to the Jewish people.
Y el demonio ha mentido bastante a la gente judía.
But God has not changed His word.
Pero el Señor no cambia su palabra.
So why would He not want you to understand Yom Teruah?
¿Por qué él no va a querer que entiendas Yom Teruah?
Well, the first part that we have to understand.
La primera parte que debes entender.
The first part that we got to understand.
La primera parte que debes
is
entender.
Is all about the shofar.
Se trata todo acerca del shofar.
Why do we sound the shofar? What does God want?
¿Qué es lo que quiere el Señor?
Why does God say sound the shofar?
¿Por qué el Señor va a decir suena el shofar?
Why are they talking about eating apples and honey?
¿Por qué él no está hablando acerca de comer manzanas?
Why is it not in the Bible to eat apples and honey?
¿Por qué no está en la Biblia comer manzanas?
Does it taste good?
Las,
yes, it tastes good.
¿Sabe bien? Sí,
it tastes
bien.
Very good. Sabe good Macintosh. That's the only good thing Macintosh is good for to eat. Okay, so why does God want us to say that?
¿Por qué el Señor quiere que
what we're going to do hacer? Now is we're going to look at the shofar.
Lo que vamos a hacer ahora, vamos a mirar el shofar.
We need to study God's word.
Necesitamos estudiar la palabra de
to
Dios.
Understand why He wants us here today.
Para entender el por qué él nos quiere aquí.
Why this holy day is associated?
Porque este día santo está asociado
with the shofar.
Con el shofar.
So turn to Numbers chapter 10, please.
Vamos a Números capítulo 10.
Numbers chapter 10.
Números 10.
Verse 1 through 10.
Versículo 1 al 10.
Now I'm going to pick up the pace a little bit. We're not going to go 3 hours tonight, unless you want to. Martin's like, yeah. There's coffee later.
Yes.
Numbers, Bamidbar 10.
Números, capítulo 10.
Verse 1 through 10.
Versículo 1 al 10.
Numbers, Bamidbar 10, verse 1 through 10.
Números 10, versículo 1 al 10.
We're going to start really delving into this holy day.
Nos vamos a empezar a profundizar en este día santo.
By understanding what the shofar means.
Entendiendo qué es lo que significa el shofar.
Like, you know, isn't this instrument different than anything else?
Este instrumento no se mira diferente que los otros.
You know, it doesn't look like anything else.
Se mira como diferente.
It doesn't smell like anything else, right?
Se huele diferente.
Okay. So, you know, so what is it? Why does God want us to do this on this day?
¿Por qué el Señor quiere que hagamos eso en este día?
All right, let's go to Numbers 10, verse 1 through 10.
Vamos a Números 10, versículo 1 al 10.
Numbers 10, verse 1 through 10.
Números 10, versículo 1 al 10.
Yehovah said to Moshe, make two trumpets, make them hammered of hammered silver, use them for summoning the community and for sounding the call to break camp and move on. When they are sounded, the entire community is to assemble before you at the entrance to the tent of meeting. If only one is sounded, then just the leaders, the heads of the clans of Israel, are to assemble before you. When you sound an alarm, the camps to the east will commence traveling. When you sound the second alarm, the camps to the south will set out. They will sound alarms to announce when to travel. However, when the community is to be assembled, you are to sound, but don't sound an alarm. It will be the sons of Aaron, the Kohanim, who are to sound the trumpets. This will be a permanent regulation for you through all your generations. When you go to war in your land against an adversary who is oppressing you, you are to sound an alarm with the trumpets. Then you will be remembered before Yehovah your Elohim, and you will be saved from your enemies. Also on your days of rejoicing and your designated times, on your Rosh Chodesh, at the sound of the trumpets, you are to burn over your burnt offerings and over your sacrifices of peace offerings. These will be your reminder before your Elohim. I am Yehovah your Elohim. Amen?
Amen.
Now look at verse 2, because Frank had this question the other day.
Miremos el versículo 2.
And God heard your question, and he wants to answer your question.
El Señor escuchó tu pregunta.
Look at verse 2.
Versículo 2.
Make two trumpets, make them hammered silver. Use them for summoning the community and for sounding the call to break the camp and move on. Amen? Mm. So Francisco had a question for me last night.
Francisco tuvo esta pregunta la noche anterior.
He said, what's the difference between these silver shofars? There are the silver trumpets and the shofar.
¿Cuál es la diferencia entre estas dos trompetas de plata y el shofar?
The silver trumpets are specifically for the temple.
Las trompetas de plata son específicamente para el templo.
Okay, and they were in the desert, the temple wasn't built.
Y esto fue en el desierto porque el templo aún no estaba construido.
But they had built a tabernacle, a mishkan.
Pero ellos construyeron un mishkan, un tabernáculo.
So in Leviticus 23,
en Levíticos 23,
it says you're to do the holy days no matter where you live.
Dice que tienes que hacer los días santos no importa dónde vivas.
So when you're out of the house,
cuando estás fuera de la casa,
you sound the shofar instead of the trumpet.
Tú suenas el shofar en vez de la trompeta.
And you'll see why in a minute.
Y vas a ver el porqué.
The silver trumpets are specifically for the temple.
Las trompetas de plata son específicamente para el templo.
Because in verse 10,
porque en el versículo 10,
it says you're to sound it over your Rosh Chodesh.
Debes sonar en tu Rosh Chodesh.
And can't you do a Rosh Chodesh anywhere, an offering anywhere?
¿Y puedes hacer el Rosh Chodesh en cualquier lado?
Yes, you can.
Sí, sí puedes.
You can do it as long as you have an altar that is built properly.
Puedes hacer mientras tú tengas un templo, un altar construido de la manera apropiada.
Right, Abraham made an offering, right?
Así como vemos Abraham,
there was no temple yet, right?
No había un templo.
Okay, so it doesn't matter where you live.
No importa dónde vivas.
So here, the trumpet.
Aquí la trompeta.
Let's learn about it.
Aprendamos.
Because it's important for Yom Teruah, right?
Es importante para Yom Teruah.
Look at verse 2.
Miremos el versículo 2.
Make two trumpets, make them of hammered silver. Use them for summoning the community and for sounding the call to break camp and move on. Amen?
Amen.
So the shofar is God's trying to call you.
El shofar es Dios, está tratando de llamarte.
That's why Yom Teruah is about remembering.
Es por eso que Yom Teruah se trata acerca de recordar.
Remembering about your sins.
Recordar acerca de tus pecados.
Remembering about your blessings.
Que te recuerdes acerca de tus bendiciones.
So God says once a year,
el Señor dice, una vez al
on
año,
this holy day,
este día santo,
I want you to remember how much I blessed you.
Yo quiero que te recuerdes cuánto te he bendecido.
Now, I've been in a lot of other countries.
Yo he estado en otros países.
And they're nice.
Ellos son
Guatemala was nice. Peru was nice. Colombia was nice.
En Colombia.
Clarabel's Colombia is nice.
Colombia is nice.
Okay. It's a nice country.
Son países bonitos.
But this is a nicer one.
Pero este país es,
this is a nicer one.
Es mejor.
I've been to Israel.
Estado en Israel.
Nice country.
Un país bueno.
Lots of people.
Mucha gente.
In a very little area.
En una área muy pequeña.
It's like going to New York City during the pagan Christmas.
Es como ir a Nueva York en la Navidad.
You ever go there like in during December?
¿Te has ido allá en diciembre?
Oh my goodness gracious, it's like you're a pinball.
Es como un juego de pinball.
But here in America, you don't have to live there.
Pero aquí en América, tú no
you can move
ahí.
To New Jersey.
Tú puedes cambiarte a
New and visit Jersey. New York whenever you want.
Y visitar a Nueva York cuando tú quieras.
The trumpet says, remember how much I blessed you.
La trompeta dice, recuerda cuánto te he bendecido.
Remember how much you got running water.
Recuerda cuánto el agua ha estado corriendo.
Electricity.
La electricidad.
Protection.
La protección.
A pretty decent country to live in, right?
Un país decente de vivir.
So God is saying, the shofar is about remembering your blessings.
El Señor dice que el shofar es acerca de recordar tus bendiciones.
Verse 2 again, please.
Versículo 2 otra vez.
Make two trumpets, make them a hammered silver, use them for summoning the community and for sounding a call to break camp and move on. Amen?
Amen.
So the community.
La comunidad.
The shofar is about the community.
El shofar es acerca de la comunidad.
So the shofar is sounding this kadosh mikra, come together.
Sonar está sonando para que esta congregación, el kadosh mikra, se reúna.
Who is the community now?
¿Quién es la comunidad ahora?
Jews.
Judíos.
And Gentiles.
En gentiles.
That's
gentiles.
Why it's saying the community.
Es por eso que se dice la comunidad.
It's not just saying the men.
No se dice solo el hombre.
It's also saying the women.
Se está diciendo la mujer también.
The yeladim, the children.
Los niños, los yeladim.
The real little children, the tof, the little children.
Los niños más pequeños.
Okay, so he wants everybody to hear.
Él quiere que todos escuchen.
Come.
Que vengan,
stop everything you're doing
paren de hacer lo que estés en
and
haciendo,
give God glory.
Y den gloria a Dios.
And if he's happy,
y si él está contento,
if God is happy,
si Dios está contento,
you're happy.
Tú estás contento.
If God is angry,
si el Señor está enojado,
you're sad.
Tú estás triste.
You see how that works?
¿Te das cuenta cómo trabaja?
Make daddy happy.
Haz que tu padre esté contento.
Then daddy makes the family happy.
Y el padre hace a la familia contento.
Make daddy angry.
Enoja al padre.
The whole family is sad.
Toda la familia se pone triste.
Okay. Now the next part of verse 2.
La otra parte.
It says, sounding the call to break camp and move on.
Es el sonar para avanzar en el campamento.
Now what does that mean?
¿Qué es lo que significa esto?
Yom Teruah is about leaving the old life.
Es acerca de dejar la vida antigua.
Of secularism.
Del secular.
Money.
Del dinero.
Pagan stuff.
Cosas paganas.
And remembering that you're walking with God.
Y recordar cuando estabas caminando. Y recuerdas cuando estés caminando con Dios.
This is why Paul the emissary, Rav Shaul.
Esto es lo que Pablo el emisario dijo.
Writes, you're a new creation.
Escribe acerca de una creación nueva.
It's not about the outside.
No se trata acerca de lo exterior.
Because you can be beautiful on the outside.
Puedes ser hermoso afuera.
And rotten inside.
Y podrido.
Anybody ever meet somebody like that?
¿Alguien ha conocido a alguien así?
Oh, he's really handsome.
Oh, él es bien, bien apuesto.
Hi, big boy. Hi. You're Hola. So nice looking.
And the guy turns out to be a real jerk, right?
Y él regresa y ha sido bien malo.
And, you know, he might meet a really beautiful girl.
Es como ves una muchacha bonita.
And she opens her mouth and it's like nails on a blackboard.
Y cuando abre su boca es como las uñas en un pizarrón.
You know, you ever have that sound?
¿Has escuchado ese sonido?
So God's saying, that's the way you were to me before I knew you.
El Señor dice, así como eras tú antes de conocerte.
But when you accept Yeshua as your Messiah,
pero cuando aceptaste a Yeshua como el Mesías,
he says, I take your sins,
él dice, yo tomo tus pecados,
and I wipe them away,
y los limpio.
And I say, he says, walk with me.
Y dice, camina conmigo.
So it's breaking camp.
Está rompiendo
breaking where you used to be.
Está rompiendo lo que tú solías
ser. The shofar reminds us.
El shofar te recuerda.
Keep walking with God.
El caminar con Dios.
Keep walking with God.
Te mantengas caminando con Dios.
That's what this holy day is about. It's not the new year.
De eso se trata este día santo. No es el nuevo año.
It's about reminding you to walk with God. God.
Recordar el caminar con Dios.
Let's look at verse 3 now.
Miremos el versículo 3 otra vez.
When they are sounded, the entire community is to assemble before you at the entrance to the tent of meeting. Amen?
Amen.
So there's different soundings that go along with this.
Hay diferentes sonidos que van con esto.
When you study the historical books,
cuando estudias los libros de historia,
you find that there's four different types of soundings.
Vas a encontrar que hay cuatro tipos de sonido.
Just like, you know, in the Revolutionary War,
como en la guerra revolucionaria.
How did the people move on?
¿Cómo la gente se movía?
They had a drummer.
Tenía los tambores.
And if the drummer drums slow, you march slow.
Si el tambor tocabas lento, tú marchas despacio.
And the faster the drummer drummed,
mientras el tambor se acelera,
the faster your pace was.
Más rápido empiezas a marchar.
And then the drummer changed what he was playing,
si el tambor cambia cuando está él tocando,
then the army would know to go to the right,
entonces el ejército va a saber si
or go to the left,
a la derecha o a la izquierda,
or to stop,
o tiene que parar.
The same goes for God's community.
Lo mismo pasa con la comunidad de Dios.
Because this is a weapon of war.
Esta es una arma de guerra.
The shofar is a weapon of war.
El shofar es un arma de guerra.
As we're going to see later on with Gideon's army.
Como vamos a ver después el ejército de Gideon.
Or in the book we talk about the walls of Jericho.
O también como las paredes de Jericó.
Okay, so there's four different soundings.
Hay cuatro tipos de sonido.
If you want to write it down,
si quieres escribirlo,
the first sounding is tekia.
El primer sonido es tekia.
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 T-E-K-I-A-H.
T-E-Q-U-I-A.
Ka.
Ka.
T-E-K.
T-E-K.
A-I-A-H.
I-H.
I won't spell them anymore. Tekia, you can make your own writing.
Tekia.
You'll know what your handwriting says.
Tekia.
Okay? The next one is Shivarim.
La próxima es Shivarim.
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 The third sounding is Teruah.
La tercera es Teruah.
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 That's why this is called Yom Teruah.
Eso por eso se llama Yom Teruah.
I'll tell you the meanings of each name in a moment. The fourth one.
Te voy a decir el significado en un momento. El cuarto.
Is Tekia Gedolah.
Tekia Gedolah.
Tekia Gedolah.
Tekia Gedolah.
Okay. Tekia means.
Tekia significa.
It's a pure, unbroken sound.
Es un sonido que no se quebranta.
So it's not super loud, but it's pure and unbroken.
No es muy muy, muy alto.
Okay, that's tekia.
Ese es el sonido de tekia.
Okay, it's an unbroken sound. It means to search.
Es un sonido que no se rompe, que significa el buscar.
So when you hear the shofar, you hear tekia. It means search your heart.
Cuando escuches este sonido, significa que busques tu corazón.
Teshuva, repent, return.
Que hagas teshuva, que te arrepientas, que regreses.
The next one, shivarim.
El próximo, shivarim.
It is a broken staccato sound.
Ese significa para.
Like your.
Un sonido que se corta muchas veces.
Okay, it sounds like this.
Que suena así.
You ever hear a child crying?
¿Has escuchado a un niño llorar?
You know, the kid falls off the chair.
El niño se cae de la silla.
Big boom.
Se escucha ese golpe.
And then you hear. That type of crying.
Ese es un niño que llora.
Okay, so that's a marching.
Esa es una marcha.
Okay, it's a marching.
Es una marcha.
Dun, 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 dun. Left, 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 right, left, 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 izquierda,
derecha,
derecha, izquierda, derecha, izquierda, derecha. Okay, okay. Teruah.
Teruah.
Is a wave-like. So you're starting to pick up the pace a little bit.
Es una como ondas que empiezas a acelerarle.
Or it's an alarm, like you ever hear a car alarm? Woo, woo, woo. Everybody's heard that, right?
Alarma de un carro.
Don't you just want to go and shoot your neighbor when that happens?
No quisieras ir y
disparar. Oh, it sounds like this on the shofar. Shut the alarm! Come on, you've heard that sound, right? That's picking up your pace.
Es escuchar esto, es mantener el paso.
It means a warning.
Eso significa una advertencia.
And then the tekiah gedolah.
Y el tekiah gedolah
is a prolonged, unbroken sound. It's a loud, final sound.
Es un sonido bien alto, bien largo.
It means sincere repentance.
Es un arrepentimiento sincero.
Okay, when you hear this one, repent because the time is about to close.
Es cuando escuchas este sonido, es porque se acerca el tiempo.
The Lord is calling us.
El Señor está llamándonos.
That's what Yom Teruah is about.
De eso se trata Yom Teruah.
Are you searching your heart?
Estás buscando tu corazón.
That's why it's not Rosh Hashanah.
Es por eso que no es Rosh Hashanah.
It's not Lashana Tova.
No es Lashana Tova.
It's a totally different understanding.
Es un entendimiento completamente diferente.
You got Yom Kippur coming up.
Tienes Yom Kippur que se está acercando.
Shivarim. Are you afraid to go into that holy place to meet face to face with God?
Estás con miedo de irte a reunirte con Dios, a reunirte cara a cara.
Because now from Yom Teruah,
porque desde ahora, Yom
Teruah, to Yom Kippur,
hasta Yom Kippur,
you got 10 days.
Tú tienes 10 días.
And you got to go to people and say, I'm sorry.
Y tienes que acercarte a las personas y pedirles
perdón. If you've said something bad,
si dijiste algo malo,
about somebody,
acerca de
or you got into a fight with somebody,
o si te has discutido con alguien,
you got 10 days.
Tienes 10 días.
Because if you go into that holy place,
porque si te vas al lugar santo,
and you ain't right,
y tú no estás
God's going to strike you dead.
El Señor te va a destruir.
Well, God's not going to strike me dead.
El Señor no me va a destruir.
No, you might not die right now.
Quizás no te mueras en estos instantes.
But when you get up there,
pero cuando llegues allá
and let
arriba,
me tell you, there is a heaven.
Y déjame te digo, hay un cielo.
And there is a hell.
Y hay un infierno.
God's going to say, I don't know you.
El Señor va a decir, yo no te conozco.
You are not fearful of me. You never said you're sorry to that person.
Tú nunca me temiste. Tú nunca le pediste perdón a esa persona.
Look at verse 4, please.
Miremos el versículo 4.
If only one is sounded, then just the leaders, the heads of the clans of Israel, are to assemble before you. Amen?
Amen.
Just the leaders.
Solo los líderes.
Now, what happened on Friday?
¿Qué pasó el día viernes?
The Lord gathered the leaders.
El Señor reunió a líderes.
All 80 leaders of the world.
Todos los 80 líderes del mundo.
Were in Israel for the funeral.
Estuvieron en Israel por un funeral.
And what did they sound?
¿Y qué sonaron?
They sounded the shofar.
Sonaron los shofares.
This was gathering the people together.
Esto es reunir a la gente.
Assembling them.
Llamarles a la asamblea.
This sounding is to gather the leaders to get their orders to move.
Este, el sonido es reunir a los líderes para darle la orden que avancen.
Yom Teruah is you are leaders.
En Yom Teruah es que tú eres líder.
We are supposed to be a holy nation.
Debemos ser una nación santa.
You're supposed to be leaders.
Estás supuestamente a ser
líderes. You're supposed to hear God's voice.
Debes escuchar la palabra de Dios.
Because what's the sound that comes out of that shofar?
¿Cuál es el sonido que sale de ese shofar?
That is God's voice.
Es la voz de Dios.
How do you know it's God's voice?
¿Cómo sabes que es la voz de Dios?
Because it's the breath that comes into me.
Porque es el aliento que sale de adentro
de
mí.
In Hebrew we call that the ruach.
En hebreos lo llamamos el
and
ruach.
And when you die, the ruach returns back to heaven.
Y cuando mueres, el ruach regresa al cielo.
So the voice that sound that you hear is a sound of God's voice.
La voz que acabaste de escuchar es el sonido de la voz de Dios.
So in verse 4 again.
En el versículo 4 otra vez.
If only one is sounded, then just the leaders, the heads of the clans of Israel, are to assemble before you. Amen?
Amen.
So God is saying, come and assemble before me. This is my day.
El Señor dice, ven y reúnete delante de mí, que este es mi día.
Tekiah. A pure, unbroken sound.
Un sonido largo, puro.
That calls the leaders.
Que llama a los líderes.
Search your hearts.
Que busquen su corazón.
What sin do you have in your heart that's holding you back?
¿Qué pecado tú tienes en tu corazón que te está reteniendo?
Okay? That's what this day is all about. That's what, why we sound the shofar.
Es por eso que sonamos el shofar.
And it's sad that the rest of the world isn't doing this today.
Que el resto del mundo no está haciendo esto.
You got unsaved Jews
judíos que no son
celebrating
salvos,
Rosh Hashanah.
Que están celebrando Rosh Hashanah.
You got the church that's out watching football.
Tienes la iglesia que está afuera mirando fútbol.
Making up their own days.
Están haciendo su propio día.
But God is saying, come to my house on my days.
Pero el Señor dice, ven a mi casa en mis días.
So I can bless you.
Así te bendeciré.
You know, when your father calls you, he wants to bless you.
Cuando tu padre te llama, él quiere bendecirte.
So he's calling the leaders in verse 4.
Está llamando a los líderes en el versículo 4.
Let's look at verse 5 and 6.
Miremos el versículo 5 y 6.
When you sound the alarm, the camps to the east will commence traveling. When you sound the alarm, the camps to the south will set out. They will sound alarms to announce when to travel. Amen. This is why you need to know the four soundings.
Es por eso que necesitas saber los cuatro tipos de sonido.
Because what's an alarm?
¿Qué es una alarma?
How do I know what an alarm is?
¿Cómo sé que es una alarma?
You know, an alarm might be a merengue to somebody.
Una alarma quizás sea un merengue.
That might be an alarm to somebody.
Quizás yo piense que esa es una alarma para alguien.
We all got to be on the same page.
Debemos todos estar en un mismo pensamiento.
So here the shofar.
Aquí el shofar.
Is sounding, come to my house.
Es el sonido. Dice, vengan a mi casa.
Travel to my house.
Ven y acércate a mi
Set
casa.
Set this day aside.
Prepara este día a un lado para mí.
Get ready for Yom Kippur.
Alístate para Yom Kippur.
10 days from now.
10 días desde
ahora. We're actually 9 since we're in day 1.
9 porque ahorita estamos en el día 1.
You're going to stand before the Lord.
Vas a estar delante del
on
Señor.
On the holiest day of the year.
En el día más santo del año.
The day that Yeshua says he marries the bride.
El día en que Yeshua dice que él se casó con la novia.
And this ties together with Matthew 25.
Y esto se junta con Mateo 25.
Remember the shout goes out.
Recuerda que el grito salió.
With
fuera.
The 10 virgins. Remember the 10 virgins.
Con las 10 vírgenes.
5 were smart.
Las 5 eran inteligentes.
And 5 were morons.
Y las otras 5 eran insensatas.
Because in the Greek it says moros. And that's where we get the word morons.
En el griego se dice tontas, por eso.
And the cry went out. The cry.
El grito salió.
The
lloro.
Cry went out.
El lloro salió.
Teruah means a crying.
Teruah significa el llorar.
An alarm, a cry.
Una alarma, el grito.
So God's saying, get ready, I'm coming.
El Señor dice, alístate que yo vengo.
In 10 days from now, the door gets shut.
En 10 días la puerta se va a cerrar.
Get shut.
Se cierra.
And those that are in the wedding go to the feast.
Y aquellos que están en la boda van a ir a la
But
fiesta.
Then there were the 5 virgins. Let us in, let us in.
Pero después estaban las otras 5 vírgenes.
And what happens?
¿Y qué es lo que pasó?
The guard says, I don't know you.
El guardián dice, yo no te conozco.
The door's locked, forget you.
La puerta se cerró.
And once God shuts the door on your life,
y una vez que se cierra la puerta en tu vida,
you're not going to be in His house.
No vas a estar en su casa.
Teruah is about traveling to God's path.
El teruah significa que vayas por el camino de Dios.
That's why Yeshua said, "I'm the way."
Por eso Yeshua dice, "Yo soy el camino."
Okay. The word derek means the way.
La palabra derek significa camino.
The road traveled.
Para ir por ese camino.
What road are you on?
¿En qué ruta tú estás?
Do you have God's GPS?
¿Tienes el GPS de Dios?
And what's God's GPS?
¿Qué es el GPS de Dios?
God's perfect system is what?
El perfecto sistema de Dios.
Everybody
es...
now. Seis uno tres. Seis uno tres. Seis uno tres. The 613 laws of God.
Las 613 de Dios.
And this is one of them.
Y esta es una de ellas.
That if you don't want to come to this holy day on the service night, that's okay.
Que si tú no quieres venir a este día santo, está bien.
But when you get to God's house,
pero cuando llegues a la casa de
and
Dios,
the door is locked,
y la puerta se esté
you
cerrada,
can bang all you want, but you ain't getting into heaven.
Tú puedes golpear lo que tú quieras, pero no vas a entrar al cielo.
Keep on knocking, but you can come in.
Sigue golpeando, pero no vas a entrar.
Traveling. Look at verse 6.
Mira el versículo 6.
When you sound the second alarm, the camps to the south will set out. They will sound the alarms to announce when to travel. Amen?
Amen.
When to travel. Teruah is about a road traveled.
Teruah es acerca por el camino donde vas a marchar.
Walk the same road as the disciples.
Camina la misma ruta que los discípulos.
And you can't go wrong with that.
Y no vas a equivocarte con eso.
Because Yeshua said to Matthew,
Yeshua le dijo a Mateo,
follow me.
Sígueme.
said to the rest of them, follow me.
Le dijo al resto de discípulos, sígueme.
Teruah is about remembering to follow Yeshua.
Teruah es acerca de recordar el seguir a Yeshua.
Verse 7, please.
Versículo 7.
Verse 7.
Versículo 7.
However, when the community is to be assembled, you are to sound, but don't sound an alarm. Amen?
Amen.
So in verse 7, you see different soundings.
En el versículo 7 ves diferentes sonidos.
You gather the people.
Reunir a la gente.
The shofar is gathering the people.
El shofar está reuniendo a la gente.
Now you're getting their attention for the message that follows.
Ahora estás poniendo atención del mensaje que estás tú siguiendo.
Let me say that again.
Déjame repito otra
you're
vez.
Sounding it a second time.
Tú suenas por segunda vez.
So they hear the message that follows.
Están escuchando el mensaje que están siguiendo.
What's the message that's going to follow us, people?
¿Cuál va a ser ese mensaje que van a estar
ten siguiendo? 10 days from now.
Los 10 días desde
the
hoy.
The day of atonement.
El día del tormento.
And don't think it was nailed to the cross.
Y no pienses que ha sido clavada a la cruz.
Because if you think it was nailed to the cross,
porque si piensas que ha sido clavado a la cruz,
let me tell you, it was resurrected 3 days later.
Déjame te digo que resucitó al tercer día.
So 3 days later, that law was resurrected.
3 días después, esa ley resucitó.
And everything went back to normal.
Y todo regresó a lo normal.
But it wasn't nailed to the cross. Yeshua was nailed to the cross.
Pero no fue clavada a la cruz. Yeshua fue
and
clavada
he ran
a la cruz.
The race to its completion.
Y él llegó a la meta hasta completarla.
That's why Paul says, run the race.
Es por eso que Pablo dice, corre esa
go
carrera.
On the path.
Ve por ese camino.
Assemble for the message.
Reúnete para el mensaje.
Now, here is a real key for this particular Yom Teruah.
Aquí hay una clave muy importante para este Yom Teruah.
Look at verse 9.
Mira el versículo 9.
And this ties together with yesterday's message, everybody.
Y esto se junta con el mensaje de ayer.
When you go to war in your land against the adversary who is oppressing you, you are to sound an alarm with the trumpets. Then you will be remembered before Yehovah your Elohim, and you will be saved from your enemies. Amen?
Amen.
Wait, that was so good, I think we should read it again. Look at verse 9. You really might want to read it and underline it.
Versículo 9.
Because this is going to happen.
Porque va a pasar.
When you go to war in your land against an adversary who is oppressing you, you are to sound an alarm with the trumpet. Then you will be remembered before Yehovah your Elohim, and you will be saved from your enemies. Amen?
Amen.
This is why the devil doesn't want the Jews celebrating Yom Teruah.
Por eso que el demonio no quiere que los judíos celebren Yom Teruah.
Oh, Rosh Hashanah Tova.
Dicen,
Happy
Shana
New
Tova.
Year. May your name be inscribed in the book of life.
Escrito en el libro de la vida.
No, the no. Shofar is about
shofar es acerca
going to battle against the enemy of
en contra
God.
Del enemigo de Dios.
Sound an alarm.
Sonar la alarma.
On my holy mountain.
En mi montaña santa.
What did we sing?
¿Qué cantamos hoy día?
Sound an alarm on my holy mountain. So blow a trumpet in Zion, Zion. Sound the alarm. Why?
¿Por qué?
So that we will be remembered.
Así seremos recordados.
You want God to remember you.
Tú quieres que el Señor te recuerde de ti.
You want God to remember your kids.
Tú quieres que el Señor
they're two
se
wonderful
acuerde
kids.
Hijos,
you want God to remember them.
Hijos hermosos. Tú quieres que el Señor se acuerde
you
de
got
ellos.
A beautiful baby girl.
Tú tienes una hermosa niña pequeña.
You got a beautiful granddaughter.
Tú tienes una nieta hermosa.
You want God to remember our children.
Tú quieres que el Señor se recuerde de tus hijos.
So you parents got to start doing what God wants.
Ustedes padres deben hacer lo que el Señor
each year God says come back.
Este año dice regresa.
Remember me.
Recuérdame.
Remember
a mí.
My holy days.
Recuerda mis días santos.
And I'll remember you.
Y yo me acordaré de ti.
I'll bless you.
Yo te bendeciré.
I'll bless your children.
Yo bendeciré a tus hijos.
How many of us want our children blessed?
¿Cuántos quieren que
no,
nuestros hijos
sean
bendecidos?
No, I don't want my kids blessed. I want my kid to get out of my house.
No quiero que mi hijo
you eat too much food.
Tú comes mucho.
You snore too loud.
Tú roncas mucho.
You don't walk the dog.
Tú no caminas al perro.
You know, who doesn't want blessings for their kids?
¿Quién no quiere bendiciones para los hijos?
God is saying, look at verse 9, everybody.
Mira el versículo 9.
When you go to war in your land against an adversary who is oppressing you, then you are to sound an alarm with the trumpets. Then you will be remembered before Yehovah your Elohim, and you will be saved from your enemies. Amen? How is the Lord going to come back?
¿Cómo es que el Señor va a regresar?
144,000 virgin Jewish men.
144,000 judíos vírgenes.
Are going to say Baruch Haba B'Shem Yehovah.
Decir Baruch Haba B'Shem Yehovah.
And what are they going to have in their hands?
¿Qué van a tener en sus manos?
They're going to have the shofar
van
in their hands.
Los shofares en sus manos.
Because it's a battle instrument.
Porque es un instrumento de guerra.
And then God will come and save Israel.
Y el Señor vendrá y va a decir Israel. Amen.
That's why He wants us remembering Teruah.
Es por eso que él quiere que recordemos Yom Teruah.
Remember us, God.
Que nos recuerde Dios.
We're here in the diaspora.
Porque en la diáspora.
We're here doing your days.
Estamos en los días.
We're setting aside this day. We're taking off from work.
Estamos apartando estos días. Estamos tomando libre en el trabajo.
This is also about repentance before you go to war.
Esto también se trata acerca del arrepentimiento antes de ir a la guerra.
You don't want to go to war when you got active sin.
No quieres ir a la guerra cuando tienes estás en pecado.
So God says, walk with me.
El Señor dice, camina
conmigo. Walk with me.
Camina conmigo.
And I will be your defense.
Y yo te defenderé.
He is my defense. I shall not be moved. He is my defense. I shall not be moved. With God as your defense.
Cuando el Señor es quien te defiende.
Nothing will stop you.
Nada te parará.
With God as your defense.
Cuando el Señor está en tu defensa.
That's why we sound the shofar every Shabbat.
Es por eso que sonamos el shofar cada Shabbat.
Calling the leaders together, calling the people together.
Llamando a los líderes, reuniendo a la gente.
Remember us, God.
Acuérdate de nosotros,
protect
Señor.
Us, God.
Protégenos, Señor.
You know there were 7,700 terrorist attacks in America this year so far. That have been stopped.
Había 77,000 ataques de América aquí en este día.
This year alone, 7,700.
En este año hubo 7,700 ataques.
So why is it starting up now even more?
¿Por qué es lo que va a empezar ahora más?
How did they get it? How did they get through?
¿Cómo ellos van a llegar a esto?
Because we got to stand for God.
Porque debemos pararnos con Dios.
We got to sound the shofar.
Debemos sonar el shofar.
We got to do God's holy days.
Debemos hacer los días santos de Dios.
And then God will remember us.
Y el Señor se acordará de
and
nosotros.
He will squish down our adversary.
Y él aplastará a nuestro adversario.
Look at verse 10.
Miremos el versículo 10.
Also on the days of rejoicing at your designated times and on Rosh Chodesh, you are to sound the shofar over your burnt offerings and over the sacrifices of your peace offerings. These will be your reminder before Yehovah, or actually Elohim. I am Yehovah your Elohim. Amen?
Amen.
Okay, also at your days of rejoicing.
También dice en los días de regocijo.
Yom Teruah is a day of rejoicing.
Yom Teruah es un día de regocijo.
Because why?
¿Por qué?
Because it's also a Rosh Chodesh, a new moon festival.
Porque también es un Rosh Chodesh, el festival de la nueva luna.
And what do we have?
¿Y qué tenemos aquí?
We have our offerings.
Tenemos la ofrenda.
We have kosher.
Tenemos kosher.
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 Kosher beef.
Carne kosher.
We got our offering. We got our challah.
Tenemos el challah.
We got our not so kosher, but I went with it anyway. We got our cakes.
Tenemos nuestros pasteles.
For our thanks offering.
Para la ofrenda de gracia.
In accordance with God's word.
De acuerdo a la palabra de Dios.
Because we want to thank the Lord.
Porque queremos dar gracias a Dios.
There's a lot of people in the world today that didn't have anything to eat.
Hay mucha gente alrededor del mundo que no tiene nada que comer.
And we're going to eat well.
Y nosotros vamos a comer bien.
On the day of rejoicing.
En el día de regocijo.
We're going to pray over our burnt offering at the end.
Vamos a orar por la ofrenda de agradecimiento.
We're going to bring our peace offering before the Lord.
Vamos a traer nuestra ofrenda de paz ante el Señor.
We're going to bring a reminder offering before the Lord.
Vamos a traer esta ofrenda de recordatorio al Señor.
Because we have heard the shofar.
Porque no hemos escuchado el shofar.
Go back to Leviticus 23, please.
Regresemos a Levítico
23. Are you learning anything so far?
¿Están aprendiendo algo?
Learning something? Ever do this at the other place, Martin? No, they didn't
do otro
that.
Lugar?
L'shana tova.
L'shana tova.
I think we might have an apple.
Yo creo que tenemos
I think Steve también. Ate all the honey, though. Leviticus 23, verse 24.
Levíticos 23, versículo 24.
Leviticus 23.
Leviticus 23.
Verse 24.
Versículo 24.
Not yet. All right. Well, everybody got it?
Amen.
Tell the people of Israel in the seventh month of the first of the month is to be for you a day of complete rest for remembering. A holy convocation announced with blasts on the shofar. Amen?
Amen.
The word blast is the word teruah, as I said earlier.
La palabra sonar se llama teruah.
Okay. It is an alarm.
Es una alarma.
A single.
Una alarma sola, simple.
Okay. It's a shout.
Es el gritar.
It is a blast of war.
Es un grito de guerra.
It is an alarm of war.
Es una alarma de guerra.
A war cry.
Una alarma de lloro.
A battle cry.
Una batalla de lloro, de it llanto.
It is a shout for joy.
Es un grito de alegría.
But let me say that again.
Déjame repito otra vez.
Okay. It's an alarm.
Es una alarma.
Okay. This is one of our keywords. It's an alarm.
Es una palabra clave. Una alarma.
It's a blast for war.
Es un sonido de guerra.
An alarm for war.
Una alarma de guerra.
A battle cry.
Una batalla de llanto.
What?
Un clamor. Un clamor.
Un clamor. Yeah, like a clamor.
Clamor.
Yeah. Yeah, a clamor of war, like a war cry, like a grouping. Let's get the word right so that in Spanish, it's like a grouping of men like shouting. Arr!
Es un grupo de hombres.
Okay, a clamor.
Un grupo de hombres gritando ese clamor.
Okay, that's mm-hmm. what we're looking for. I want if we have to get a Spanish word, then because I didn't give this to Rav Ed where he had the chance to look it up in the Spanish dictionary. This happened this afternoon. Okay. There's only so many hours in the day. Okay. So the word blast is most of all an alarm.
La palabra sonar más que todo es una alarma.
Or a cry.
O un llanto.
A cry out to God.
O un clamor, un grito a Dios.
The word, the Hebrew phrase Yom Teruah.
La palabra Yom Teruah.
Literally means.
Literalmente significa.
A day of shouting cries.
El día de gritar, un clamor de grito.
Now why would you cry out?
¿Y por qué tú clamas?
If you got a sick child.
Porque si tienes un niño enfermo.
Teruah, cry out to God.
Teruah, el gritarle a Dios.
You don't got a job.
Llamar a Dios.
You need a job.
Necesitas un trabajo.
Teruah, cry out to God.
Pídele a Dios.
You're in pain.
Estás con dolor. Clama
cry
a Dios.
Out to God.
Clama a Dios.
You got something going bad in your life. Cry out
algo,
to God.
Algo que está yendo mal en tu vida. Clama a Dios.
Teruah, that's what the word is. Teruah.
Teruah, eso es lo que la
so
palabra es.
This day, once a year,
este día, una vez
God
al año,
wants you crying out to Him.
El Señor quiere que clames hacia Él.
The word teruah.
La palabra teruah.
I don't know how we're going to translate this, so help everybody help in Spanish. Okay? It is the Hebrew word for like shrill, like
es como crujir.
Como a un screech.
Crujir. Como un crujir.
Like crujir. your car, you know those cars by your house?
Yes.
And you know the ones with the crappy mufflers?
Uh-huh.
They think they're a race car, but they're not.
I know.
It's a Honda. You know, come on, guys. It's a Honda. Bee! You know, and they're at the light. It's that sounding, and they're stepping on the brake, or they drop it in from neutral into drive, and they kill the transmission. And, you know, eee! You know, I have that by my house all the time.
It's a crujir.
Okay? Yep. That's, okay, you got that understanding?
Yes.
It's a shrill.
Es un crujir.
Okay, it's a shout, a cry, an alarm.
Es un clamor, un crujir, una alarma.
Now the best way to understand this.
La mejor manera de entender.
The best way to understand teruah.
La mejor manera de entender teruah.
Is by looking at the references throughout the scripture.
Es mirar las referencias por medio de las escrituras.
So, okay, now let's go to Numbers 10 again.
Vamos otra vez a Números 10.
Okay, verse 5 and 6.
Versículo
We're going to start
5
there.
Versículos 5 y 6. Vamos a empezar ahí.
Because we're going to see the word Teruah.
Vamos a ver la palabra Teruah.
Numbers 10.
Número 10.
Verse 5 and 6.
Versículo 5 y 6.
Numbers 10.
Números 10.
Verse 5 and 6.
Versículo 5 y 6.
When you hear the word alarm.
Cuando escuches la palabra
alarma. Or see the word alarm, that is the word Teruah in Hebrew.
Cuando mires la palabra alarma, es la palabra Teruah en hebreo.
When you sound the Teruah, the camps to the east will commence traveling. When the sound, a second Teruah, the camps to the south will set out. They will sound Teruah to announce when to travel. Amen?
Amen.
So this Teruah is this camps will get moving.
Este Teruah es los campos que están moviéndose.
Hearing this sound stirs your heart to move towards God.
Escuchando este sonido hace que tu corazón se mueva.
That sound of the shofar should have stirred your heart.
Como el sonar el shofar, esto debería hacer que tu corazón cruje. Perdón. Se estremezca.
Okay. I remember a long time ago when my wife Kelly heard the shofar for the first time, she fell over. Not forward, but backward into her chair.
Yo recuerdo la primera vez que mi esposa escuchó el sonido del shofar, se cayó para atrás.
It touched her heart so deeply.
Le estremeció su corazón mucho.
Because it's a sound of God's voice.
Porque es el sonido de la voz de Dios.
She was like, I've never heard anything like that.
Ella dijo, yo no he escuchado nada de esto.
Hearing the sound should make you want to move away from sin.
Escuchar esto te debería hacer que te muevas del pecado, que
Teruah
te alejes del pecado.
Is about moving away from sin.
Teruah es acerca de alejarte del pecado.
Well, what is sin?
¿Qué es pecado?
How do I know what sin is?
¿Cómo sé que es
Everybody
pecado?
Everybody now, seis uno tres, seis uno tres, seis uno tres. That's how I know what sin is.
Eso es como sé que es un pecado.
This alarm, this Teruah, this shrill.
Esta alarma, este Teruah, este crujir.
Is about understanding that Yom Kippur is coming.
Es entender que Yom Kippur se acerca.
So it's very interesting.
Es muy interesante.
With this information.
De esta información.
Why God called 80 world leaders.
Porque el Señor reunió a 80 líderes.
To Israel on Friday.
A Israel en un viernes.
And they heard the sound of the shofar.
Y escucharon el sonido del shofar.
Because Shimon Peres wanted it sounded at his funeral.
Porque Shimon Peres él quería que lo suene en su funeral.
It was in his will.
Fue en su voluntad.
So God had everything planned.
El Señor planeó todo.
God had everything planned.
El Señor tenía todo planeado.
He wants us to move away from pagan ways.
Él quiere que nosotros nos alejemos de las vías paganas.
And towards His ways.
Y nos acerquemos a sus caminos.
And that's what Teruah is about.
De eso se trata, Yom Teruah.
Turn to Numbers chapter 31 now.
Vamos a Números 31 ahora.
Numbers chapter 31 now.
Números 31.
Anybody learning anything?
¿Están aprendiendo?
It's good to see all you all here today. At the end, we're going to have the kids sound their homemade shofars.
Al final vamos a tener a los niños sonando los shofares hechos en casa.
If they're awake.
Si están despiertos.
Numbers, Bamidbar 31, verse 1 through 9.
Versículo números 31, versículo 1 a 9.
Teruah is about you will have victory over your enemies.
Teruah es que tú vas a tener victoria sobre tus enemigos.
That you'll have victory over your enemies.
Es una victoria sobre tus enemigos.
Numbers 31, verse 1 through 9.
Números 31, versículo 1 al 9.
Yehovah said to Moshe, on behalf of the people of Israel, take vengeance on Midian, the Midianim. After that, you will be gathered to your people. Moshe said to the people, equip men from among yourselves for war. They are to go out and fight Midian in order to carry out Yehovah's vengeance on Midian. You are to send to war 1,000 men from every tribe, every one of Israel's tribes. So out of thousands of people in Israel, 1,000 armed men from each tribe, 12,000 altogether were mustered for war. Moshe sent them 1,000 from each tribe to the war. He sent with them Pinchas, the son of Eleazar, the Kohen of to war, with the holy utensils and the trumpet for sounding the alarm in his care. They fought against Midian, and Yehovah ordered Moshe and killed every male. They killed the kings of Midian along with their The others were slain, Avi, Rechim, Zor, Hur, and Reva. The five kings of Midian, they also killed Balaam, the son of Beor, with the sword. The people of Israel took captive the women of Midian and their little ones, and they took as booty all their cattle, flocks, and other goods. Amen? Teruah is about this victory.
Teruah se trata acerca de esta victoria.
Now, what's very interesting,
algo muy interesante,
is they went to war against Midian.
Fueron a guerra, a una guerra en contra de Midian.
Why is that important to understand for Teruah?
¿Cuál es este, lo importante de aprender?
Because remember, de Teruah? Remember Yitro, Moshe's father-in-law,
recuerda, Yitro era el suegro de Moisés,
was a priest of Midian.
Fue el sacerdote de Midian.
Moses said, "Stay with us."
Moisés le dijo, "Quédate con nosotros."
And God will bless you.
Y el Señor te bendecirá.
But Yitro said, "What?"
¿Y qué dijo Yitro?
No thanks, I'm going to go back to my own people.
Él dijo, "No gracias, me voy a regresar donde mi propia gente."
So if you hear the truth,
so si escuchas la verdad,
let the truth set you free.
Deja que la verdad te libere.
And don't go back to doing the things you're not supposed to.
No regreses a hacer las cosas que no estás supuesto a hacer.
So Teruah is about remembering.
Teruah es acerca de
that
recordar.
God will be with us when we go to war.
Que el Señor va a estar con nosotros cuando vayamos a la guerra.
So you might go to war at work.
Quizás tengas una guerra en el trabajo.
You might want to do certain things.
Quizás quieras hacer otras cosas.
And people are stopping you from doing certain things.
Y la gente te va a parar por hacer algunas cosas.
Sound that shofar.
Suena ese shofar.
Sound that shofar.
Suena ese shofar.
Let the Lord know you're here.
Deja que el Señor sepa que tú
estás aquí. Let the Lord know that you're following His ways.
Déjale saber al Señor que tú estás siguiendo sus
caminos. And that person is a pagan at work.
Y esa persona es un pagano en el trabajo.
Lord, I was supposed to have that better position.
Yo, Señor, yo debía haber estado en esa posición mejor.
Sound the alarm.
Suena esa alarma.
Teruah.
Teruah.
Look at verse 6.
Versículo 6.
Moshe sent them 1,000 from each tribe to the war. He sent them and Pinchas, the son of Eleazar, the Cohen, to the war, with the holy utensils and the trumpets for sounding the alarm in his care. Amen?
Amen.
When you go out to war,
cuando vas a la guerra,
you better bring a priest with you, and I'm not talking a Catholic priest.
Es mejor que traiga un sacerdote contigo.
I'm talking a Kohanim. You must be the Kohanim.
Tú debes ser ese sacerdote.
Because we're supposed to be a royal priesthood.
Porque debemos ser una nación santa.
And when you go to battle,
una nación sacerdotal,
you bring the tools, the weapons of war.
Y cuando vayas a la batalla, trae tu arma.
You let the enemy know you're coming.
Déjale saber al enemigo que tú estás llegando.
God's people don't do anything in secret.
La gente de Dios no hace nada en secreto.
We let the enemy know exactly what we're going to do.
Le dejamos saber al enemigo exactamente lo que
because
vamos
we got
a hacer.
A great commander of our army.
Porque tenemos un buen comandante de nuestro
Look at verse 2.
Versículo 2.
On behalf of the people of Israel, take vengeance on Midian. After that, you will be gathered to your people. Amen?
Amen.
You're going to take vengeance on those who left God.
Vas a tener venganza de aquellos que se han alejado de Dios.
God's going to sound His alarm.
El Señor va a sonar su alarma.
God's going to sound His alarm.
El Señor va a sonar su alarma.
And then you're going to, if you're not with Him.
Si no estás con Él.
If you're not with Him.
Si no estás con Él.
If you're not with Him.
Si no estás con Él.
You're against Him.
Tú estás en contra de
él. I'm covered in the blood of Jesus.
Pero estoy cubierto en la sangre de Jesús.
You're covered in something, but not that.
Tú estás cubierto en algo, pero no en la
I want to be covered with God's hand.
Yo quiero estar cubierto con las.
I want to be covered with my Messiah's blessings.
Yo quiero estar cubierto con las bendiciones.
And let me say something.
Y déjame digo.
Messiah is the same yesterday.
El Mesías es el mismo
ayer, today,
hoy día,
and forever.
Y por siempre.
And he never stopped being a Jew.
Y nunca dejó de ser un judío.
He never was.
Nunca fue,
and never will be a Catholic,
será un católico,
a Protestant,
un protestante,
a Baptist,
un bautista,
an evangelical.
Un evangélico.
Yeshua is and always will be
Yeshua
a Jew.
Es y será un judío.
And you can have His blessings
y tú puedes tener sus bendiciones
if you come under His wings.
Si vienes bajo sus alas.
And what's at the end of the wing?
Y que está al final de sus alas.
The laws of God.
Las leyes de Dios.
They're for all people.
Es para toda la gente.
Because if you say that, then we're not under the law anymore.
Porque si tú dices que no estamos bajo la ley, nunca
then
más.
You can go steal.
Entonces puedes ir a robar.
If you say we're not under the law anymore,
si tú dices que no estamos bajo la ley,
then you can go look at a pretty woman or a pretty man.
Entonces tú puedes salir y mirar a hombres.
You look so nice, Gabriel. I love that color on you.
Te miras muy apuesto, Gabriel.
Okay? So if you say that we don't need these things anymore, that's cool.
Si tú dices que no necesitamos estas cosas,
then God will go to battle against you.
Entonces el Señor te hará la guerra.
And he will take vengeance on you one way or another.
Y él se vengará de ti de una u otra manera.
But even though a lot of people think they're walking with God,
incluso mucha gente piensa que está caminando con Dios.
Look at verse 9 and let's see what happens.
Mira el versículo 9 y mira qué es lo que está pasando.
The people of Israel took captive the women of Midian and their little ones, and they took as booty all their cattle, flocks, and other goods. Amen?
Amen.
God said to destroy them all.
El Señor dice que lo destruye a todos.
Because they were a cursed people.
Porque fueron gente maldecida.
He didn't want any of them in his camp.
No quería nadie de ellos en su campo.
So Israel had a blessing.
Israel tuvo una bendición.
They won the war.
Ganó la guerra.
They won the war.
Ganó la guerra.
They won the war.
Ganó la guerra.
But then they lost their blessing.
Y después perdió la guerra.
So you can hear the shofar.
Tú puedes escuchar el shofar.
Turn from your wicked ways.
Regresa de tus caminos.
And then 2 weeks from now.
Débiles.
And then 2 weeks from now.
Y en dos semanas desde ahora.
Go right back to your old ways.
Vas a regresar a tus viejos caminos.
Once you hear the truth.
Una vez que escuches la verdad.
Let it set you free.
Deja que te libere.
Let it set you free.
Deja que te libere.
Teruah is about that warning, that cry.
Teruah es acerca de esa advertencia, de ese clamor.
Let's go to the next reference of Teruah.
Vámonos a la próxima referencia de Teruah.
Turn to the book of Yehoshua, Joshua.
Vamos al libro de Josué.
Oh, that's terrible. Yehoshua, Joshua, chapter 6.
Josué, capítulo 6.
Don't make it too muddy.
No, I'm just the volume. I'm just adjusting. Because you're clipping.
I'm clipping?
Yeah, you're clipping on the master.
Joshua 6, verse 4 and 5.
Josué 6, versículo 4 y 5.
Teruah is about the walls tumbling down.
Teruah es acerca de las paredes temblando.
If you believe in your obedience.
Si tú crees en tu obediencia.
Joshua 6.
Josué 6.
Verse 4 and 5.
Versículo 4 y 5.
Everybody got it? Say amen.
Todos tienen amen.
Seven Kohanim are to carry seven shofars in front of the ark. And on the seventh day, you're to march around the city seven times. And the Kohanim will blow the shofars. Then they are to blow a long blast on the shofar. And hearing the sound of the shofar, all the people are to shout loudly as they can. And the wall of the city will fall down flat. Then the people are to go up into the city, each one straight from where he stands. Amen?
Amen.
Teruah is about.
Teruah es acerca.
Walls coming down in your life.
Las paredes cayéndose en tu vida.
Let me say that again. Maybe you didn't hear it. I only heard one amen.
Déjame repito otra vez. Quizás no escuchaste.
Teruah is about walls coming down in your life.
Teruah es acerca de las paredes derrumbándose en tu vida.
They sounded the shofar.
Suenan el shofar.
The cry went out.
El clamor salió.
The teruah went out.
El teruah salió.
And the walls came tumbling down.
Y las paredes se derrumbaron.
So on teruah,
en teruah,
let the walls come down that separate you from God's blessings.
En teruah, deja que las paredes se derrumben para que tú te separes de las bendiciones de Dios.
Let me say that again.
Déjame repito otra
on
vez.
On teruah,
en teruah,
let the walls come down.
Deja que las paredes se derrumben.
Let the walls come down.
Deja que las paredes se derrumben.
That separate you from God's blessings.
Que te separen a ti de las bendiciones de Dios.
That's why God said, remember.
Por eso es lo que el Señor dice, recuerda.
I'm right outside your walls, he says.
Estoy afuera de las paredes, dice él.
But God is a gentleman.
Pero el Señor es un caballero.
He stands knocking at the door.
Él está llamando a tu puerta.
Yeshua says, I stand knocking at the door.
Yeshua dice, yo voy a estar llamando a la puerta.
I'm not going to break your walls down.
Yo no voy a derrumbar las paredes.
You have to break your walls down.
Tú tienes que derribar tus paredes.
You got to walk around.
Tú tienes que caminar alrededor.
You got to walk around.
Tú tienes que caminar alrededor.
You got to march.
Tú tienes que marchar.
Now, what were they doing? They were marching.
¿Qué estaban haciendo?
They
estaban
were marching.
Marchando. Estaban marchando.
You got to march.
Tienes que marchar.
You got to march.
Tienes que marchar.
You got to march. Come
tienes
on, everybody.
Marchar.
Hey! Why did the chicken cross the road? You gotta march with God.
Tienes que marchar con Dios.
That's what the Lord wants. He wants you in His army.
Eso es lo que el Señor quiere. Él te quiere en su ejército.
But He can't if your walls are too high.
Pero no puede si tus paredes son muy altas.
Yes, He can jump over your walls.
Sí, Él puede saltar sobre tus paredes.
But He's asking you, tear down the wall.
Pero Él te está pidiendo que derrumbes esas paredes.
Teruah is about being obedient.
Teruah se trata acerca de ser obediente.
It's about being obedient.
Se trata acerca de ser obediente.
It's about teaching our children obedience.
Se trata de enseñar a nuestros hijos obediencia.
How can you say to your child, honor your mother and father?
¿Cómo puedes decirle a tu niño, honra a tu padre y a tu madre?
And you don't do what it says.
Y tú no haces lo que dice.
How can you say that to your kids?
¿Cómo le puedes decir eso a tus hijos?
Keep the Sabbath holy.
Mantén el sábado santo.
But you're not here with God every single Shabbat.
Pero tú no estás aquí con Dios cada Shabbat.
How can you teach your children to respect you?
¿Cómo vas a enseñar a tus hijos que te respeten?
If they see that you're a hypocrite.
Si ellos ven que tú eres un hipócrita.
You know, my mother would say.
Mi madre solía decir.
Don't smoke. It's a terrible habit.
No fumes, ese es un hábito terrible.
My father said, no, don't smoke, it's a terrible habit.
Decía que no fumes,
you know, my
eldest
sister died from complications of smoking.
Por complicaciones por culpa del cigarrillo.
Bladder cancer.
Un cáncer
al... Most smokers die from bladder cancer.
Muchos fumadores mueren por cáncer a la vejiga.
Okay, because the stuff that you smoke into your body,
porque todo lo que está entrando a tu cuerpo,
gets filtered out through your kidneys,
está filtrándose en tus riñones,
and then it, you go pee-pee,
y tú te vas a pipí,
and it gets out of you,
y sale de ti.
So if you're showing your children bad habits,
estás enseñando a tus hijos unos hábitos malos,
then you're not walking in God's blessings.
Entonces no estás caminando en las bendiciones de Dios.
Teruah reminds us to walk in the blessings of God.
Teruah nos recuerda el caminar en las bendiciones
and
de Dios.
Sound the alarm at the right time.
Y sonar la alarma en el tiempo preciso.
Teruah is about remembering our disobedience.
Teruah es acerca de recordar nuestra desobediencia.
And not fearing God's wrath.
Y no temer a la vara de Dios.
Turn to the book of Ezra.
Vamos al libro de Ezra.
Ezra chapter 3.
Ezra capítulo 3.
Ezra, what a guy, Ezra.
Ezra, capítulo 3.
Anybody learning something here tonight?
¿Están aprendiendo algo aquí?
It's not Rosh Hashanah.
No es Rosh Hashanah.
You never heard something like this on Yom Teruah for 13 years.
No has escuchado nada de esto.
That's terrible. You didn't hear this in the Christian church, right?
No has escuchado esto en la iglesia cristiana.
Don't tell me, I'll be sad. 13. Huh? Oh, you were there 13 years, man. Ezra chapter 3.
Ezra, capítulo 3.
Verse 10 through 13.
Versículo 10 al 13.
This is for those. This scripture is for those people that I just mentioned.
Esta escritura es para esa gente que acabé de mencionar.
Ezra 3, verse 10 through 13.
Esdras 3, versículo 10 al 13.
Everybody got it?
¿Todos tienen?
When the builders laid the foundation of the temple of Yehovah, the Kohanim and the rolls with the trumpets, and the Litvaim, the sons of Asaph, with cymbals, took their places to praise Yehovah as David, king of Israel, had instructed. They sang antiphonically, praising and giving thanks to Yehovah, for He is good, for His grace continues forever. Amen. Towards Israel, all the people raised a great shout of praise of Yehovah, because the foundation of the house of Yehovah had been laid. But many of the Kohanim, Litvaim, and the heads of fathers, clans, The old man who had seen the first house standing on its foundation wept out loud, Teruah. When they saw the house, this house, while others shouted out loud for joy, so that the people couldn't distinguish the noise of the joyful shouting from the noise of the people weeping. For the people were shouting so loudly that the noise could be heard at a great distance. Amen? Look at verse 11, please.
Miren el versículo 11, por favor.
They sang antiphonally, praising, giving thanks to Yehovah, for he is good and his grace continues forever towards Israel. All the people raised a great shout of praise to Yehovah because the foundation of the house of Yehovah had been laid. Amen? The word shout is the word teruah.
La palabra, la gran voz es la palabra teruah.
Why are they doing this?
¿Por qué están haciendo esto?
This is what we're reading is about is the second temple.
Lo que estás leyendo es acerca del segundo templo.
Because the first temple had been destroyed.
Porque el primer templo fue destruido.
How could pagans destroy God's house?
¿Cómo pueden los paganos destruir la casa de Dios?
Because God left.
Porque el Señor los dejó.
Because we didn't want to follow him in spirit and in truth.
Porque no quisimos seguirlo a él en espíritu y en verdad.
So here they raised the great teruah.
Aquí ellos levantaron este gran teruah.
Because we finally came home.
Porque finalmente regresamos a casa.
Yom Teruah is about coming back home.
Yom Teruah se trata acerca de regresar
de vuelta a casa. It's not about having your name inscribed in the book of life.
No se trata acerca de tener tu nombre inscrito en el libro de la vida.
It's not about a new year's.
No se trata acerca del nuevo
it's
año.
It's about coming, remembering that we were outside the house, everybody.
Se trata acerca de recordar porque estuvimos fuera de la casa.
Why do we have to lose everything to come back to God?
¿Por qué tenemos que perder todo para regresar a Dios?
Why do 6 million Jews have to die to finally come back to God?
¿Por qué tuvieron 6 millones de judíos que morir para regresar a Dios?
You know, when they, in 1948, when they came back to the land.
Cuando en el 1948, cuando regresaron a la tierra prometida.
That's when they finally danced with the Torah.
Ahí es cuando finalmente ellos bailaron con la Torah.
But it took 6 million Jews to die first.
Pero les tomó 6 millones de judíos que mueran.
Because God wants us to remember.
El Señor quiere que nosotros recordemos.
Every year he wants us to remember.
Cada año él quiere que recordemos.
That's why it's Yom Teruah, not Rosh Hashanah.
Es por eso que es Yom Teruah y no Rosh Hashanah.
I want you to remember.
Yo quiero que recuerdes.
That you blew it.
Que tú lo.
You messed up. You made
tú
an error.
Tú hiciste un error y lo
and
te
I
equivocaste.
Had to kick you out of my presence.
Y tuve que mandarte de mi presencia.
Because your sin was so great, I couldn't stand your smell anymore.
Porque tu pecado era bien grande y no podía estar junto, no podía soportar ese olor nunca más.
Yom Teruah is about remembering that we got kicked out.
Yom Teruah se trata acerca de recordar que fuimos echados fuera.
Look at verse 12.
Versículo 12.
But many of the Kohanim, Levim, heads of fathers' clans, the old men who had seen the first house standing on its foundation wept out loud when they saw this house, while others teruah out loud for joy. Amen. They saw it rebuilt.
Ellos vieron la
they saw the temple rebuilt.
Vieron la reconstrucción del templo.
And the older people knew that the first temple had been there.
Y todo, y la gente sabía que el primer templo estaba, había estado ahí.
See, once you know the truth,
una vez que sabes la verdad,
sometimes you get angry.
Muchas veces te enojas.
How could my Christian pastor have lied to me?
¿Cómo mi pastor cristiano me pudo mentir?
Because Yeshua talks about it.
Porque Yeshua está hablando de
the
esto.
Blind leading the blind.
El ciego guiando al ciego.
How did the Jews get so misled?
¿Cómo los judíos se
descarrieron? Lashana Tova. Happy New Year.
Tova. Feliz año.
What are you talking about?
¿De qué estás hablando?
There's nothing to do with today.
No tiene nada que ver con esto.
Well, it's the planting season again.
Es la época de plantar la
stop semilla. Smoking the pot.
Deja de fumar marihuana.
How difficult is this to understand?
Qué difícil es entender esto.
But when you don't love God.
Pero cuando no amas a Dios.
When you love yourself more than God.
Cuando tú amas a tu persona más que a Dios.
You must love Yeshua for with your hearts.
Tú deberías amar a Yeshua
your
con
mind,
tu corazón, tu mente,
your soul,
tu alma,
and your strength.
Y tu fuerza.
Look at verse 12.
Mira el versículo 12.
But many of the Kohanim, the Levim, and heads of their father's clans, the old men who had seen the first temple, the first house standing on its foundation, wept out loud, Teruah, when they saw this house, while others shouted out loud for joy. Amen?
Amen.
Why must we lose everything?
¿Por qué debemos perder todo?
That's why we're doing Yom Teruah.
Es por eso que hacemos Yom Teruah.
So we teach our children.
Así le enseñamos a nuestros hijos.
To remember God's things.
A recordar las cosas de Dios.
But if we're not doing them ourselves.
Pero si no estamos haciendo por nosotros.
Our kids are going to say, you got to go to that thing, Dad.
A nuestros hijos no les va a importar.
Why do we got to go with him?
¿Por qué tenemos que ir donde?
Yeah, right? That's what you said.
¿Verdad?
You're like, psh, Dad.
Dicen papá.
That's what these kids are saying.
Es lo que los niños dicen.
But let me tell you, kids.
Déjame te digo.
Algo. I'm a Jew.
Yo soy un judío.
And I'm preaching about Messiah Yeshua.
Yo predico acerca del Mesías
real.
Jesús. Él es verdadero.
And there really is a heaven.
Y en verdad está en el cielo.
And there really is a hell.
Y hay un infierno también.
And hell ain't a party.
Y en el infierno no hay una fiesta.
Hell's not a party.
En el infierno no hay fiesta.
You might think it's cool, I'm going to be with my friends.
Piensas que sea bien bonito ser mis amigos.
You might think that's cool.
Piensas que esté bien.
But let me tell you,
déjame
this
te
book
digo.
Is real.
Lo que él habló es verdad.
It's the oldest book in the world.
Es el libro más antiguo del mundo.
And it tells of our screw-ups.
Y dice, habla acerca
nobody
de nuestros,
would ever write a book about screw-ups. I'm going to write a book about screw-ups. These are all my screw-ups. I did this. They're crying because they're telling everybody we messed up.
Ellos están llorando porque le están diciendo a todos que no cometimos errores.
Teruah is about remembering.
Teruah es acerca de recordar.
Remembering the good.
Recordar lo bueno.
And remembering not to do the bad.
Y recordar el no hacer lo malo.
It's not about Rosh Hashanah.
No es acerca de Rosh Hashanah.
I'll have some apples and honey.
Tengo manzanas y miel.
It's about remembering that there is a God.
Es acerca de recordar que hay un Dios.
That when this nation is being overrun.
Que cuando esta nación sea apoderada de.
By taking over by
que,
evil.
Que se apodere el mal se apodere de esta
God
nación.
God will protect
el Señor
his
protegerá
people.
A su gente.
God will protect his people.
El Señor protegerá a esta nación.
And the shofar reminds us that God will protect.
Que el Señor nos va a proteger.
Turn to Psalm 89.
Vamos a Salmo 89.
Psalm 89.
Salmo 89.
Verse 13 to 15.
Versículo 13 al 15.
Psalm 89.
Salmo 89.
Verse 13 through 15.
Versículo 13 al 15.
Psalm 89.
Salmo 89.
Verse 13 through 15.
Versículo 13 al 15.
When you got it, say amen. You okay back there, J-Lo? Psalm 89, verse 13 through 15.
Salmo 89, versículo 13 al 15.
It's right near. It's in the middle. All right, cool. Your arm is mighty. Your hand is strong. Your right hand is lifted high. Righteousness and justice are the foundation of your throne. Grace and truth attend you. How happy are people who know the joyful shout, Teruah. They walk in the light of your presence, Yehovah. Amen?
Amen.
Look at, amen?
Amen.
Look at verse 14. Let's start there.
Mira el versículo 14. Empecemos ahí.
Righteousness and justice are the foundation of your throne. Grace and truth attend you. Amen?
Amen.
What is righteousness? Let's look at this verse.
¿Qué es justicia? Miremos este verso.
What is righteousness?
¿Qué es justicia?
It's your alarm. Nobody. Okay. Anyway, what is righteousness? Juan's alarm.
¿Qué es justicia?
What is that? Every time the alarm goes off now,
cada
you're
going to
think
alarma,
of righteousness.
Vas a pensar en justicia.
Because you're doing this for Camila.
Porque estás haciendo esto por Camila.
She's beautiful.
Ella es bonita.
She deserves the best one.
Ella se merece lo mejor.
And you can give her the best.
Y tú puedes darle lo mejor.
And it's in your hand.
Y está en tu mano.
You can give her righteousness.
Tú puedes darle lo justo.
And she can be the princess that she already is.
Y puede ser ella la princesa que ya lo es.
We can give our children blessings.
Podemos darle a nuestros hijos las bendiciones.
If we teach ourselves righteousness.
Si nos enseñamos a nosotros el ser justos.
What is justice?
¿Qué es justicia?
What is justice?
¿Qué es justicia?
Treating people in accordance with Torah.
Tratar a las personas de acuerdo a la Torah.
Treating people.
Tratar a las personas.
How God wants them treated.
Como el Señor quiere que los tratemos.
What is truth?
¿Qué es verdad?
Yeshua said, "I am the way, Yeshua the dice, truth."
Yeshua dice, "Yo soy el camino, la verdad."
Emet. Emet in Hebrew. Emet.
Emet en hebreo.
Emet is truth.
Emet is truth.
What is truth?
¿Qué es verdad?
Well, you have to know what righteousness is.
Debemos saber qué es justicia.
What is righteousness?
¿Qué es justicia?
The Torah of God.
Es la Torah de Dios.
That's how we know how to treat one another.
Eso es como tú vas a saber cómo tratar a
otra persona. Do we allow sin into our house?
¿Permitimos que el pecado
entre en
nuestra casa?
Yes, can I bring my loaded gun into your house, please?
¿Puedo dejar ahí el pecado en mi casa?
Can I bring my bag of cocaine into your house?
¿Puedo traer mi bolsa de cocaína a tu casa?
Just put it under your seat, please.
Solo pone bajo tu asiento,
please. No, officer, that's not my cocaine.
No, oficial, esa no es mi cocaína.
I don't know how it got there.
Yo no sé cómo llegó allí.
Okay? Righteousness.
Justicia.
Righteousness is part of God's throne.
Esta justicia es la parte del trono de Dios.
But the key here, why we're talking about this psalm,
pero la palabra clave que estamos hablando aquí en este
is
salmo,
verse 15.
Es versículo 15.
Look at verse 15.
Miren el versículo 15.
Because the word teruah is found there.
Es la palabra teruah que se encuentra en el verso 15.
How happy are the people who know the joyful teruah? They walk in the light of your presence, Yehovah. Amen?
Amen.
How happy you're going to be.
Qué feliz voy a estar.
It doesn't say how sad you're going to be.
No dice que voy a estar
oh man,
triste.
I'm going to walk in those laws.
Voy a caminar en esas paredes.
I'm going to walk in those 613 laws.
Voy a caminar en sus leyes.
Who can tell me if the Jets won today?
¿Quién me puede decir si los Jets ganaron hoy día?
¿Quién me puede decir si los Gigantes ganaron? I'm walk in those laws.
Oh, tengo que caminar
en esas
leyes.
I'm here and the football game's on.
Voy aquí en este en la congregación.
All my friends are at the go-go bar.
Mis amigos están en la go-go bar.
All my friends are watching the game at the go-go bar.
Mis amigos
sucking down some brewskis.
Están tomando, bebiendo.
Mucho cerveza, man. And I'm over here and going to walk in these
aquí,
laws.
Y tengo que caminar en sus leyes.
What does God say?
¿Qué es lo que el Señor está diciendo?
Does God say we're supposed to be sad walking in His commandments?
¿El Señor acaso dice que debemos
he
estar
says,
tristes
how
caminando
happy!
En sus leyes? Él dice,
happy, I'm
que
happy!
Feliz.
I used to be a drunk.
¿Tú
I was a happy
ser un
drunk.
Borracho? ¿Cómo es un borracho
I was a happy
feliz?
Drunk.
Yo era un borracho
some sad
feliz.
Drunks.
También hay borrachos tristes.
There are some really sad drunks.
También hay borrachos tristes.
Okay? Happy
felices.
Are people who walk in the teruah.
La gente que camina en su teruah.
Walk in His ways.
Camina en sus caminos.
And then you're going to shout for joy.
Entonces vas a gritar un clamor de júbilo.
Because what's the last part of the sentence?
¿Cuál es la última parte de la oración?
Walk in the light.
Camina en la luz.
There's a song that goes, come house of Jacob, let us walk in the light, walk in the light, walk in the light. Come house of Jacob, let us walk in the light, walk in the light of the Lord. The haughty man is humbled, arrogance abates, for the Lord alone will be exalted in that day when every knee shall bow and every tongue confess that Yeshua is the Lord unto the glory of God. Look at verse 15.
Mira el versículo 15.
Teruah is all about that.
Teruah habla acerca de todo esto.
How happy are the people who know the joyful shout. They walk in the light of your presence. Yehovah, amen?
Amen.
Walking in His presence. Who doesn't want to walk in the presence
caminar
of God?
En su presencia. ¿Quién no quiere caminar en la presencia de Dios?
Oh, that's too much for me.
Es mucho para
I'm
mí.
I'm going to watch the Jets go lose another game. You know, I want to go watch the Mets lose, and the Yankees lost too.
Y los Yankees también perdieron.
I'm not gloating or nothing, but anyway. Walking in the presence of the Lord.
Caminar en la presencia del Señor.
That's what this is all about. Why?
De eso se trata.
Because what did it say?
¿Qué dice ahí?
You will be remembered.
Tú serás recordado.
Teruah is about walking in His presence.
Teruah se trata acerca de caminar en su presencia.
Look at verse 14 again.
Miremos el versículo 14 otra vez.
Look at 14 again.
Versículo 14.
14 and 15, sorry.
14 y 15.
Righteousness and justice are the foundation of your throne. Grace and truth attend you. How happy are the people who know your joyful shout and walk in the light of your presence, Jehovah. Amen.
Amen.
Now, a lot of people say that they don't see this in the New Testament.
Mucha gente dice que no ven esto en el Nuevo Testamento.
You don't see Yom Teruah in the New Testament.
Dicen que no ven Yom Teruah en el Nuevo Testamento.
Really?
Really, ¿verdad?
Look at verse 15, and what was the word for shout?
Mira el versículo 15, ¿cuál es la palabra?
What's the Hebrew word for shout?
Para
Teruah.
Teruah.
What goes before it?
¿Qué es lo que estaba antes?
The righteousness.
El justo.
Okay, righteousness is tied together with Teruah, right?
El justo se junta con Teruah.
Hold your place in your Bible.
Mantén tu lugar en la Biblia.
Go to Matthew 5.
Vamos a Mateo 5.
Go to Matthew 5.
Mateo 5.
Matthew 5, verse 6.
Mateo 5, versículo 6.
Matthew 5.
Mateo 5.
Hold your place. I'm going to come back to the Psalm there.
Mateo 5, mantén tu lugar.
Matthew 5, verse 6.
Mateo 5, versículo 6.
That's in the New Testament.
Eso está en el Nuevo Testamento.
Right in the beginning.
Al principio.
Matthew 5, verse 6.
Mateo 5,
when you got it, 6. Say amen.
Cuando lo tengas, di amén.
How blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness. They will be filled. Amen?
Amen.
Righteousness, if you're hungering for God's ways,
justo si estás hambriento de los caminos de Dios,
then sound the shofar.
Entonces suena el shofar.
You're hungering for God's ways. This is what Yeshua was talking.
Estás hambriento de los caminos de Yeshua.
Remember, who was Yeshua talking to?
Recuerda con quién está hablando Yeshua.
He's talking to the Romans, right?
Está hablando a los romanos, ¿verdad?
Talking to the Catholic Church, right?
Está hablando a los católicos, ¿verdad?
The Pope was there in nombre de Padre, nombre de Hijo, nombre de Espíritu Santo. No, who was he talking to?
¿Con quién está hablando?
He's talking to a bunch of Jews.
Está hablando con un grupo de judíos.
What were the Jews doing?
¿Qué es lo que los judíos están haciendo?
They would be celebrating the biblical holy days.
Ellos estarían celebrando un holiday santo.
They would read the Psalms.
Ellos estarían leyendo los salmos.
Look at verse 6 again.
Mira el versículo 6 otra vez.
How blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled, amen? Amen. Who doesn't want to be filled?
¿Quién no quiere ser saciado?
If you don't want your blessings, I'll take them. Who doesn't
si
want
no
your blessings?
Las bendiciones, yo
Oscar?
Lo tomo. Oscar?
You've been married, you just got married.
¿Tú recién te casaste?
You got just married under the chuppah.
¿Te casaste
Come on,
bajo
you,
la
you got Betsy. She's enough of a blessing. Come on, give me him.
No?
No? No, Darwin, you just got married a couple weeks ago.
Darwin, también te casaste.
You better get under those blessings, my man.
Tienes que estar bajo las bendiciones.
You better hunger and thirst for righteousness.
Es mejor que estés hambriento y sediento
por la justicia.
Somebody's
going to take that fine-looking woman of yours.
O alguien va a tomar esa muchacha tan bonita.
You got to hunger and thirst for God's ways.
Tú vas a tener que estar hambriento y sediento por las vías de Dios.
Yom Teruah is about hunger and thirsting
acerca de estar hambriento y sediento
for God's ways.
Por las vías de Dios.
Thirst for His ways.
Sediento por sus caminos.
Hunger.
Hambriento.
Hunger. Is anybody a little hungry?
Lamb.
No, is it lamb? No, we got beef.
Beef.
We got beef. Ooh. Ooh. Ah, qué lindo. Rico. Rico suave. You got a hunger. You don't just hunger for food. You hunger for the food from God.
Debe estar hambriento no solo de la comida, sino de Dios.
Every day God brought down the manna from heaven, right?
Cada día el Señor envió el maná desde el cielo.
That's what Yeshua was talking about. Hunger.
Eso es lo que Yeshua está hablando.
Because you put walls in front of God.
Porque tú pones paredes en frente de Dios.
Sound the shofar. Break down the walls.
Suena el shofar. Derrumba las paredes.
Cry about the lost time.
Clama acerca a Dios todo el tiempo.
Because you weren't walking with God.
Porque tú no estás caminando con Dios.
Go back to Psalm 89.
Regresemos a Salmo 89.
Psalm 89.
Salmo 89.
Verse 14 and 15 again, where I told you to hold your place.
Versículo 14 y 15.
Righteousness and justice are the foundation of your throne. Grace and truth attend you. How happy are the people who know the joyful Teruah. They walk in the light of your presence, Yehovah. Amen?
Amen.
They walk in your presence.
Ellos caminan en tu presencia.
Why are they walking in the presence?
Porque estás caminando en la presencia de Dios.
Because they're hungering and thirsting for what?
Porque están hambrientos y sedientos de qué?
Give me another one, Mr. Bartender.
Dame una más de esta.
Why is the room spinning?
¿Por qué el cuarto está dando las vueltas?
Stand still, Oscar.
No te muevas, Oscar.
Okay, why are they hungering?
Porque ellos están hambrientos.
Because they want more blessings in their life.
Porque quieren más bendiciones en su vida.
Turn to Matthew 24.
Vamos a Mateo 24.
Now I'm going to show you where Messiah says he's coming back on this day.
Te voy a enseñar dónde el Mesías dice que va a venir en este día. Mateo 24.
Matthew 24.
Mateo 24.
Verse 30 and 31.
Versículo 30 y 31.
Matthew 24.
Mateo 24.
Verse 30 and 31.
Versículo 30 y 31.
Then the sign of the Son of Man will appear in the sky. All the tribes of the land will mourn as they will see the Son of Man coming in the cloud, coming on the clouds of heaven with tremendous power and glory. He will send out his angels with a great shofar, and they will gather together his chosen people from the four winds and from one end of heaven to the other. Amen?
Amen.
What is he going to come back with?
¿Con qué es lo que él va a regresar?
The shofar.
Con el shofar.
When do we sound this? When are we commanded to sound the shofar?
¿Cuándo estamos comandados a sonar el shofar?
Yom Teruah.
Yom Teruah.
Do you gotta be there?
¿Tienes que estar ahí?
No.
No.
You gotta choose to be there.
Tú debes escoger el estar ahí.
You gotta look for the moon.
¿Vas a mirar la luna?
You gotta be ready to sight the moon.
¿Vas a estar listo para avistar la luna?
You gotta be ready for his holy days.
Vas a estar listo para sus días
santos.
Because
Messiah can show up at any time.
Porque el Mesías puede asomar en cualquier
hora. Once that temple is built.
Una vez que el templo sea construido.
Not until the temple is built.
No hasta que el templo se construya.
Not until the offering starts.
No hasta que la ofrenda empiece.
And then 7 years.
Después 7 años.
Then.
Después.
Look at verse 31.
Después el versículo 31.
He will send out his angels with a great shofar, and they will gather together his chosen people from the four winds, from one end of heaven to the other. Amen. With a Yom Teruah, a great Teruah,
un gran Teruah,
he's going to send out his angels.
Va a mandar a sus ángeles.
How many holy days are we commanded to sound the shofar?
¿Cuántos días santos estamos comandados a sonar el shofar?
Rosh Kodesh, every Rosh Kodesh.
Cada Rosh Kodesh.
But when is the great shofar?
Pero ¿cuándo es el shofar
Teruah.
Grande? Yom Teruah.
Okay, that's what's commanded.
Eso es lo que está mandado.
Now at the end of Sukkot.
Y en el Sukkot,
you have the water pouring on the last day.
Tienes el agua que se derrama en el último
and
día.
And associated with the shofar, but not the great shofar.
Y se asocia con el shofar, pero no con el gran shofar.
Now, what happens if we don't follow him?
¿Qué pasa si no lo seguimos a él?
Let's see what's in our future.
Miremos qué hay en nuestro futuro.
Let's see what else the shofar tells us is what's going to happen.
Miremos qué más nos va a pasar.
Our job is to stop this from happening in our lives.
Nuestro trabajo es parar esto que no pase en nuestras vidas.
Turn to Revelation chapter 8.
Vamos a Apocalipsis capítulo 8.
Revelation chapter 8.
Apocalipsis capítulo 8.
Verse 6 through 13.
Versículo 6 al 13.
Revelation 8. Is the coffee started?
Apocalipsis 8.
Revelation 8, verse 6 through 13.
Versículo 6 al 13.
When you got it, say amen. That's the last book.
Amen.
Go to the end and make a left. Okay. And then make a left. Revelation 8, verse 6 through 13.
Apocalipsis 8, versículo 8 al 13.
No, Revelation 8, verse 6 through 13.
Apocalipsis 8, versículo 6 al 13.
Sí. Now the seven angels with the seven shofars prepared to sound them. The first one sounded a shofar, and there came hail and fire mingled with blood. And it was thrown down upon the earth. A third of the earth was burned up. A third of the trees were burned up, and all the green grass was burned up. The second angel sounded his shofar, and what looked like an enormous blazing mountain was hurled into the sea. A third of the sea turned to blood. A third of the living creatures in the sea died, and a third of the ships were destroyed. Third angel sounded his shofar, and a great star blazing like a torch fell from the sky. A third of the rivers and into the springs of water. And the name of the star was bitterness. And a third of the water became bitter, and many people died from the water that had been turned bitter. The fourth angel sounded his shofar, and a third of the sun was struck, a third of the moon was, and a third of the stars, so that a third of them were darkened. The day had a third less light, the night likewise. Then I looked, and I heard a lone eagle give a loud cry, as if it flew in mid-heaven. Woe! 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 To the people living on earth, because of the remaining blasts of the three angels who have not yet to sound their shofars. Amen? Amen?
Amen. Amen.
Look what happens in the first one. Let's go back to verse 7.
Vamos a ver lo que pasa en el primero. Regresemos al versículo 7.
The first one sounded his shofar, and there came hail and fire mingled with blood, and was thrown down upon the earth. A third of the earth was burned up, a third of the trees were burned up, and all the green grass was burned up. Amen?
Amen.
What happens if all that's burned up?
¿Qué pasa si todo se quema?
You got nothing to eat.
No tienes nada que comer.
No grass, no cows.
No hierba, no vacas.
No grass, no goats.
Si no hay hierbas, no hay borregos.
Okay, and all you're going to have, what are you going to have to eat left after that?
¿Y qué vas a comer después de eso?
Pig.
Cerdos.
And you can't eat that either.
Y no puedes comer eso.
So God is saying, if you don't follow my days,
el Señor dice, si no sigues mis días,
this is after the seven seals.
Esto es después de los siete sellos.
This is after much has happened.
Después de que todo esto haya pasado.
Now once again, Yeshua talks about the shofar.
Yeshua está hablando una vez más acerca del shofar.
Because this is a revelation from Yeshua,
esta es una revelación
to
de
his
Yeshua,
angel,
a sus ángeles,
who gave it to Yohanan, John.
Quien le dio a Yohanan, Juan.
Look at verse 8.
Mira el versículo 8.
The second angel sounded the shofar on what looked like an enormous blaze. A blazing mountain was hurled into the sea. A third of the sea was turned to blood. A third of the living creatures in the sea died, and a third of the ships were destroyed. So, amen?
Amen.
What happened there?
¿Qué pasa ahí?
We didn't have any land animals, see?
Si no tienes ningún animal que puedas comer.
Now you got a third of the sea animals are dead.
Ahora tienes la tercera parte de los animales del mar que
All
van muerto.
Because why?
¿Todo por qué?
Because you didn't remember to follow His holy days.
Porque tú no recordaste seguir sus días santos.
That's why he says Yom Teruah.
Es por eso que dice Yom Teruah.
Remember.
Recuerda.
Remember.
Recuerda.
Remember my days.
Recuerda mis días.
Teruah, remember my ways.
Teruah, recuerda mis vías.
Let's go to our final scripture.
Vamos a nuestra escritura.
Did you learn something
final
here today?
Aprendiste.
Let's go to, back to Leviticus 23.
Vamos a Levíticos 23.
Leviticus 23.
Levíticos 23.
Verse 24.
Versículo 24.
This is a little bit different than Rosh Hashanah, don't you think?
Este es un poquito diferente a Rosh Hashanah.
That's why Satan doesn't want anybody doing it.
Esto por eso no le gusta a Satanás que nadie haga esto.
And all we have done is study the word of God.
Y todo lo que debes hacer es solo estudiar la palabra de Dios.
Leviticus 23, Vayikra 23, verse 24.
Levíticos 23, versículo 24.
Tell the people of Israel, in the seventh month, the first of the month, is to be for you a day of complete rest, for remembering. A holy convocation announced with blasts on the shofar. Amen?
Amen.
Yom Teruah is about the people.
Yom Teruah se trata acerca de la gente.
Coming to God's house.
Venir a la casa de Dios.
Yom Teruah.
Yom Teruah
is about your hearts.
Se trata acerca de tu corazón.
Yom Teruah.
Yom Teruah.
It's about.
Se trata.
Not where you've been.
No donde estabas.
But where you're going.
Sino donde tú vas.
Yom Teruah.
Yom Teruah.
Is a day that we commemorate for our God.
Es un día donde conmemoramos para nuestro Dios.
It isn't a day to spend the morning on Facebook.
No es un día que debemos emplear en Facebook.
It's a day that we spend totally in God's presence.
Es un día donde debemos emplear de estar todo el día en la presencia de Dios.
It's Yom Teruah.
Yom Teruah.
It's a day to remember.
Es el día de recordatorio.
Where you used to be before you accepted Yeshua in your heart.
¿Dónde solías estar antes que aceptes a Yeshua en tu corazón?
Yom Teruah.
Yom Teruah.
Is about remembering.
Es acerca de recordar.
How God has blessed us.
Cómo el Señor nos ha bendecido.
Yom Teruah is remembering that there is a God in heaven.
Es recordar que hay un Dios en el cielo.
Yom Teruah is about a God that does forgive.
Es un que es acerca de un Dios que sí perdona.
As we read in Ezra.
Como leímos en Ezra.
God does bring His people back to His house.
El Señor trae, reúne a su gente de regreso a su casa.
But remember, we had to go to captivity first.
Pero recuerda, tenemos que ir al cautiverio primero.
And you don't ever know if you're going to come back from captivity.
Tú no sabes si regresarás de ese cautiverio.
Yom Teruah is about.
Yom Teruah se trata.
Making a choice to walk with God.
Hacer y escoger para caminar con Dios.
Yom Teruah is saying, I don't want to go back to the old life.
Es decir, yo no quiero regresar a la vida vieja.
But most of all,
pero lo más importante, Yom Teruah
is about remembering God's promises.
Es acerca de recordar las promesas
and
de Dios.
That you are His child.
Y tú eres su niño.
Amen.
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 Amen. Why don't we just bow our hearts for one moment?
Y then
we'll get the kids.
Nuestros corazones en un momento.
Thank you, Lord, for your blessings today.
Gracias, Señor, por tus bendiciones.
Thank you, Lord, for your forgiveness.
Gracias, Señor, por tu perdón.
We're going to offer an opportunity right now.
Vamos a dar una oportunidad.
If you're feeling in your heart,
si tú sientes en tu corazón,
that you're in a sinful place,
que tú estás en un lugar pecaminoso,
and you want to get back to God,
y tú quieres regresar a Dios,
Yeshua is knocking on your heart today.
Yeshua está llamando a tu corazón.
If you don't know where you're going to be 1,000 years from now,
si tú no sabes dónde vas a estar después de 1,000 años,
let me introduce my Messiah to you.
Déjame te introduzco a mi Mesías.
Yeshua is the foretold Messiah.
Yeshua es el Mesías dicho del que se habló.
He came to give you an opportunity to get to heaven.
Él vino a darte una oportunidad para que llegues al cielo.
And that first step is this.
Y el primer paso es esto.
That you got to believe He's Messiah.
Debes creer que Él es el Mesías.
That you got to believe you're far away from God.
Que tú debes creer que tú estás muy lejos de
and
Dios.
That you want to get back to His house.
Y tú quieres regresar a su casa.
Yom Teruah is about calling you home.
Yom Teruah se trata el llamarte a la casa.
So I'm going to lead in a simple prayer.
Te voy a llevar en una oración.
If you've never accepted Yeshua into
si
your heart.
Si nunca aceptaste a Yeshua en tu corazón.
Say these words.
Di estas palabras.
But mean them in your heart.
Pero siéntelos en tu corazón.
Yeshua, say Yeshua.
Di Yeshua.
I'm far away from you.
Yo estoy muy lejos de ti.
But I hear your calling today.
Pero escucho tu llamado hoy día.
I hear you knocking on my heart.
Yo escucho que estás llamando a mi corazón.
I ask for your forgiveness.
Te pido perdón.
I ask you to wash me.
Te pido que me laves.
Clean me.
Que me limpies.
Make me something new.
Hazme algo nuevo.
If you've said that for the first time,
si tú has dicho eso por primera
and
vez,
really meant it in your heart,
y en verdad lo sientes en tu corazón,
then you are born again.
Entonces has nacido de nuevo.
But Yeshua said this,
pero Yeshua dice esto,
that if you do not profess me before man,
si tú no me profesas delante del hombre,
I cannot and will not profess you before my Father and His angels.
Yo no puedo ni lo haré ante mi Padre y sus ángeles.
So if you've accepted Yeshua for the first time in your life,
si tú estás aceptando a Yeshua por primera vez,
slip up your hand so we can pray with you.
Levanta tus manos, así oraremos contigo.
Yes? Amen.
Amen.
If you're hearing this on radio or television or internet,
si estás escuchando esto en radio y televisión o internet,
just let us know so we can pray with you.
Déjanos saber, así oraremos por ti.
In your name, Yeshua.
En el nombre de Yeshua.
Amen.
Amen.
We have two that accepted.
Tenemos dos que van a aceptar.
Amen.
Amen.
Well, let's pray over you.
Oremos.
Amen.
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 Nothing better than a husband and wife coming. Long overdue. I would say so, but that, hey, he's knocking on your heart. He's a gentleman. Let's anoint you first, Gabriel. This is oil from Israel, virgin olive oil. I ask, Lord, that you give your son Gabriel your anointing. I ask as we pour this oil on his head that it would run down his beard as the anointing ran down Aaron's beard. I ask, Lord, that you touch his life. I ask you to make him a man of virtue, a man of character, a man who walks in your footsteps each and every day. I ask you to guide his heart to your perfect truths and your perfect ways. In your name, Yeshua. Amen.
Amen.
I thank you for Luz, Lord. I ask you for a special blessing on her. I ask you to warm her heart to your ways. I ask that this be the saddest day of her life, as you will make each and every day that goes forth from here even better. I ask that you anoint her mind to understand your word. I ask that you give her a thirst and a hunger for your righteousness. I ask that you bless her with your hand upon her heart. In your name, Yeshua, amen.
Amen.
And I ask that you bless this marriage. I ask that you keep them strong as marriage stands as a testimony of your love and your compassion for us. As we are to be servants to one another, protect their marriage always and make their house a house filled with shalom. In your name, Yeshua. Amen.
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 Amen. All right. Do you guys remember the sounds? Okay. Now we're gonna do tekiah, right? Everybody know tekiah? That's a long sound, right? Not too long, right? Okay, so everybody, tekiah. Now blow your shofar. Now we're gonna do shivarim. It's one that goes doot, 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 doot. Okay, we're gonna do that one, everybody. Shivarim. Well, come over here, you banana head. Stand over there now. All right, let's do shivarim. One, two, three. Amen. Yay. All right, Benny. All right. The third one is Teruah, when it goes woo. You ready? One, two, three. Hey! All right, and the last one, we're gonna make it the big, real loud one. Tekiah Gadolah, the real loud one. Real loud. Mila, you gonna do it real loud and real long? All right, everybody. One, two, three. Let's give a big hand.
Shalom. This is Messianic Rabbi Andrew Dinnerman. I would personally like to thank you for tuning in to the Remnant's Call each and every week. You can listen to the full message on our website, bethgoyim.org. If you have drawn closer to the King of Kings, learned more about Him today, we are blessed. If you are blessed by these messages, please consider a donation to our ministry. You can go to our website, bethgoyim.org. That's bethgoyim.org, and click on the donate button. You do not have to have a PayPal account to donate. All you need is a debit card. Once again, thank you very much for listening to The Remnant's Call.
if you have not taken your first steps to be born again, just ask God's help. Remember, it's His loving grace that has come to find you. No one is worthy or able to reach God, but God can reach us, and He's reaching out to you now. Just open your heart and let Him in. His arms are open, and the blessing of salvation and eternal life are waiting for you. Don't let it wait any longer.
Shalom. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord lift His face and shine upon you. May the Lord be gracious unto you and give you His shalom.
Shalom. My name is Messianic Rabbi Andrew Dinnerman, and I invite you to come to visit our congregation. If you are in the tri-state area, come out and visit with us on Shabbat. We are a congregation of Jews and Gentiles living as one in the Messiah Yeshua. BGMC is a place of true worship. The focus never wanders from the Hebraic roots of our faith. Beth Goyim is rooted in the Word of God from Bereshit through to the Book of Revelation. Messiah's strong words against man-made tradition are carefully recorded in Matthew 7. That is the reason we only follow the straight-up instructions found in Scripture. Truly, the way, the truth, and the life. If you're looking for a deeper walk with Adonai, come out for our Tuesday evening Bible study called Messianic Torah Time. Come, spend a day with us on any Shabbat. We start at 11 a.m. with the sound of the ancient Hebrew shofar. Next, we offer our King praise and worship in English, Hebrew, and Spanish. After worship, we review the headlines in the previous week's news from around the globe, especially news from the Holy Land Israel. We don't just list the news headlines as current events, but we comb through the scriptures, searching for clues to understand what they mean, and then to help pinpoint prophetically our current position on Adonai's clock. After digesting all that modern information, we leave the world behind as we journey with our Adonai deep into His eternal word. Not with just one or two scriptures, but usually seven or more scriptures. The spiritual nourishment and the richness of His kingdom become accessible to the ones who share this special time and seek them out. The day does not end there. Because Shabbat is so special to Him, there is always so much more that our King desires to share. So instead of separating and leaving, we stay together as a family for potluck lunch and an afternoon study of our King's Word. We close the Shabbat together with the reading of the new week's parashah. That's the Torah portion. Even after those blessings, many of us just can't get enough. So the members bring prepared homemade foods to share while we all enjoy an uplifting movie together. If all that information is not quite enough, you can check out our website where you will find over 200 video teachings and biblical holy day studies. Under Messianic Torah Time, the Hebrew Roots button, you'll discover free studies on many, many different topics, including PowerPoint slide presentations. If Beth Goyim sounds like a place you'd love to visit, but you live outside the tri-state area, there is still a way to connect with us. We stream live on the internet on Tuesday, Thursday, and Shabbat. The website is www.bethgoyim.org. That's BEHGOYIM.org. Our phone number is 973-338-7800 or 978-2-YESHUA. That's 978, the number 2, Yeshua. Shalom.